Okay, guys, welcome. This is Nüfly session 26. Thank you for joining us this Saturday. I am one of your four hosts today. My name is Daniel. I am the creative director here at Nüfly. Follow me on Instagram or Twitter at DAKFU. I'm gonna hand the microphone over now to Belinda. You're on mute, Belinda.
I'm on mute again. All right.
You're on mute again.
Wait, I can't hear Belinda.
Yeah, no.
You keeps, muted me.
Sorry.
The host keeps automatically muting.
Sorry, I was trying to turn it off. Okay, you guys are back on.
It's because when you try to speak it or unmute yourself, it mutes you back. So it's like,
gotcha.
The world does not want to hear me talk. All right.
What up,
Belinda? Hello. What's up? Good morning. Good afternoon. I'm Belinda, the editor-in-chief here at Nüfly. You can find me on all platforms under at underscore ZenRapid. Cool. I'm going to pass the mic over to Kaz now.
What's up, y'all? Good afternoon. It's Kaz logging in. Welcome to Nüfly stream. Hope everyone's doing okay. And much gratitude for this last couple of days. Y'all pulled through. But first, I want to introduce my boy, Don.
What's up, y'all? My name is Don. Back again, session 26.
Yes.
I work here, and you can find me at underscore UOP, all platforms.
Nice. All right, well, guys, today we have a pretty open format kind of session. We wanted mainly to dedicate today's session to highlight Care Package 1. I know we've been talking about it during our past streams a lot. We've been sharing with you as much as we can, but there are still some surprise elements that we held back. So we're kind of dedicating this stream to have us be able to talk about it, share stories, maybe share what we learned. The first hour is dedicated to basically debriefing and unpacking from the 3 months of work that we've done. And for the second hour, we're gonna go ahead and share our screens with you guys to have you guys be able to see basically like the creation process and how we were able to come up with everything we made for this, from website, launch layouts, videos, motion graphics, photo shoots, you name it. So for our third hour, we're gonna bring in some of our homies, our contributors. They will be joining us, and we'll have like a open table discussion. We'll be asking certain questions just to get everyone curious, to be able to talk to one another, leave comments for one another. I know some of we haven't shipped out any of the packages yet, so I'm sure like our chat hasn't even listened to our contributors' mixes, but we're actually playing in the background right now, so that's a fun little gift for whoever is joining us for this stream and our friends and family. The music that you're hearing in the background right now, this first mix is from our friend Isaiah Saab. Kick back.
He's in the room right now too.
Oh, word.
What up, Isaiah? Shout out to Isaiah from New York. Thanks,
what's
dude.
Goody? Hey. What's goody?
What's up, Linda? let's go ahead and kick this off. Don, I know you shared this story before. Can you share it again now that people have context? How did this idea of Care Package 1 begin?
What?
In other words, the story with Kenta.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, sure. Yeah. So, I shout out to Anthony Rogers. He's the founder of Bob Cut Magazine. He reached out to me on IG, started following him. I noticed that he posted something about a free coaching lesson and like a business coach lesson. And he posted Kenta Thomas. He shout out to Kenta. He's out in Germany right now, but I set up a session for our team, and we kind of just like, I felt that we needed to kind of like come together more because we were kind of like all over the place. So as a team at Nüfly, so we set up a meeting, kind of had a discussion about like what our priorities are, what our intentions are. We kind of have like a mission statement for Nüfly. It's like, you know, artists for artists, mental health and like creativity, art therapy. And based on those pillars, we kind of just created, or we wanted to do a project together, our first project ever together. And Kenta kind of showed us the way on like, you know, finding those small wins and like doing small projects instead of like trying to conquer this huge task that we were facing on building a magazine. So he kind of communicated that, try to break it down, make it, you know, smaller, do smaller projects together so it can kind of lead up to that, and celebrate smaller wins as well. So that kind of gave us the idea of let's, and that was like the beginning of COVID, right? So like everybody's facing like this shelter in place, we're all going through some sort of anxiety, we're not used to all this shit. So we thought about it as a team, like what if we created something for the people, or for like us, something that we can like make sure that we're not alone in this together, and like we could like pull together as a community, as friends and family, all that. So that was kind of like the beginning stages, and yeah, like we slowly turned into this.
Yeah, basically. Just to add on that, some of the things that we talked about, Kenta, during the consultation, we were trying to talk about kind of like, we're a really young team. We had a lot of ideas, and it's usually like whoever thought of the idea kind of leads that idea. But that kind of made some mess going down later, like with some of our work where, you know, like deadlines were kind of falling through, like things were kind of up in the air. One of the things we took away from Kenta also was having a little more structure in our team's responsibilities. And you know, we identified, you know, our like particular positions, and those positions are more so to identify the responsibilities that this individual has to pull through for. That just gave our team a lot more structure, a lot more accountability, and
expectations.
Yeah, you know, the expectations, because at the end of the day, like, the four of us are all, you know, individuals, we're all freelancers ourselves. I think one of our team's biggest challenges when we were first coming together, we're kind of syncing up on a vision. And I really liked what Kenta said when he was recommending to us, like, do smaller projects, you know, with smaller projects, you know, have that kind of like catapult you guys into being able to complete bigger projects by maybe even combining snippets of these smaller projects, celebrate those wins together. I think what's great also, thinking about it in retrospect, by having these smaller projects, it allows us to put our visions together a lot more better, right? Like, we can now understand like exactly what's in someone's head, you know, like when we're talking about like our particular aesthetic. I think also really importantly, we kind of set that foundation for what it takes to launch anything, whether it be like future merchandise or future products. Yeah, this whole small project really kind of opened up a lot of things that I think we kind of overlooked, or maybe we didn't have a reason to prioritize right away. I think one of the biggest ones was website. I didn't realize that we didn't even have a website. And you know, putting that all together, you know, like, we just didn't have like a reason, you know, we had difficulty prioritizing, I think. And now with responsibilities and now with a clear small project in mind, we had the idea of like thinking about, you know, what we could give back to, you know, what we could do in response to COVID also, right? That's actually one of the biggest reasons why we decided that we wanted to donate proceeds to Riza, because from our world as freelancers, our income is based on gigs that we, you know, schedule for ourselves throughout a year going forward. It determines like what equipment we can buy. It determines how much food we could really splurge on, how much, you know, weed we could pick up in like the next couple of weeks. Like, all of these things are based off of our gigs. And when COVID hit, a lot of us in this kind of economic situation, like, it really hit us really hard. So seeing how our community was responding was very inspiring. A lot of people were really vocal about, you know, staying indoors, you know, like sheltering in place, avoid, you know, going out as much as possible. But we saw a few homies, one of them being Riza, actually using what they do best to give back to the community. And for her, we had her on our stream, and she told us that she literally used up her entire like personal inventory, her own time, created these masks that were donated to frontline workers and basically anyone who reached out to her, right, Belinda?
Yeah. Basically, she supplied like multiple hospitals across multiple state lines. Mm-hmm. She was working with hospitals in New York, mm-hmm. in Texas, here across the state. I think there's a couple more states that she worked with too. But yeah, I felt like her effort was just really amazing.
Yeah.
She is well deserved for sure.
Yeah. And so she came up in conversation while we're conceptualizing what this care package would be, that we wanted some of the proceeds to be donated to someone who has been putting in that work as a freelancer themselves to be able to help the community respond to COVID-19. So I think when we were talking about the particular contents of what Care Package 1 would have, we originally had the idea that we wanted to make candles as merchandise already. Our team, I remember like one of these evenings, we came together, we went down Valencia and we went candle shopping, just to kind of browse like what scents do we like. Yeah, and I was kind of looking at packaging, trying to get a feel of like what are on the shelves right now that it's available for people. I think we all really like lavender. Belinda found a candle that had lavender and lemongrass, and I bought one of those also, and I thought that was a really, really relaxing scent to have lit when you are working. It's really relaxing, but it made me feel really focused also. So we knew for sure.
I think we should take a step back.
Okay.
So I think the whole premise behind, or the intention behind us doing candles, like we wanted to create merchandise that was very intentional, yes, especially during this time.
Yes.
And then it's like, when we met up before we went to go scent shopping or browsing, we thought about something like why a candle, right? Mm-hmm. And like, what's the intention behind a candle when you light a candle?
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's like, it's usually celebratory. It's usually, mm-hmm, setting a mood. You do it when you relax. Yes. It's like aromatherapy and stuff like that. And, you know, we wanted to put intention behind the whole product too. Like, mm-hmm, we're not just making a candle just to make a candle, you know? So, mm-hmm, yeah, that's kind of what I wanted.
No, that you hit the nail on the head. I totally forgot about that. It wasn't candle just because like, oh, candle sounds nice.
Yeah,
cool.
Because originally the idea that we had for merchandise beginning was like clothing, right? And then we were talking about like clothing's a little passive, you know, not that we're not going to do clothing, but we wanted to like, how can we, you know, get a merch product that speaks to like our particular audience, and our audience we think are people who operate very intentionally. Like, if I buy this, there's a reason. If I wear it, there's a reason. And that led into the idea of candles, because we personally like candles, maybe like when we're in a specific situation, whether it be like working home late at night, or like when we're all working together at the office, it just makes an overall nice experience that everyone's like enjoying simultaneously.
Smells good.
It smells good. And I think all of us own candles, right? The four of us, like without even really like being specific about that.
I mean, you're the reason why I started picking up candles in the first place.
Well, there you go.
It's because you, I think, what did you bring? You brought in like a lavender.
It was a lavender candle from Target.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I started religiously buying that.
Yeah.
I have, and like, it just really set the environment, you know? Mm-hmm. And I think what we wanted to do with this care package was like to give you an experience. Like, it's not just you're buying, you know, an item, but like we're really curating a whole experience for you, you know, to decompress. Yeah. I think it's just, yeah, better to have coming at it from like an experience standpoint.
Yeah,
we're gonna say Cass, sorry.
Oh, nothing. I was just adding to the combo, but I have like four like bottles of like candles right here, just burnt out.
Same.
They're like cup holders. They're like,
I got like
holders
two
now
empty glasses. Yeah, I don't know what to do with it.
Which is why I'm glad that we approached Natalie with making a ceramic vessel, because now you can repurpose it and you can drink tea out of it.
Yeah.
And I just got a whole bunch of Breathe Deep tea bags that will be going into all of the care packages.
Nice.
So when you finish the candle, you can drink some tea that will help you breathe a little bit better. And yeah.
Nice.
I wanted to replace my janky box that I put my pens in. So.
Hey. Repurposed. So that was content. That was the candle content. For the poster zine, I was piggybacking off the idea that Kenta said, like, when you do these small projects, potentially maybe be able to take assets from these small projects to roll over into your bigger project. The idea behind the poster zine and why it wasn't just a poster was, I thought by having a zine part, it would be like an exercise for our team to create pages. You know, these pages will be kind of like building blocks to the layouts for our magazine.
That was such a struggle too. We were fighting over four pages.
Yeah.
And we're trying to do a 200 page art book.
Yeah, I think with the art book, I think with more of these small projects, I think like, the difficulties.
I think we just have to set the tone, you know? Because we hadn't quite gotten that down yet. We hadn't put out something like this before.
Right.
So it was really just a trial run to see how we can work together Right. I think we have a better sense of how to work together and where, you know, what the foundation of our branding is and how to approach it.
Because that's partially like my responsibility too. I feel like I have like a lot of like layouts and like things in my head, but then like it's not until we actually work together that it's like, okay, I think like not only you guys better understand what's going on in my head, but I have a better understanding of what's going on in my head. So that's the idea behind why we thought like a poster zine, but also like, dude, like I don't think I've ever seen a poster zine within my proximity like recently. Like I don't think anyone's really doing that.
Where was the first time you saw one?
It was from a graphic it was from a printing company that I follow on Instagram. Mm-hmm. And they shared one of their works, and I remember just thinking about it, like, damn, that looks
tight.
That's really good design.
Like, that's the thing about the internet. You'll see like all the dope shit in the world, like
right.
You'll see like when you're in graphic design school, you're pretty much seeing all like the dopest print ever.
Right, right.
You don't see the everyday like, oh, you know, brochure or whatever or prints.
Right, right.
It's dope to see one in the wild. Yeah.
Yeah, that's it's really just bringing back to like the mental health approach when you're going through like social media. I think it's really important when you see other people's work to not kind of be like intimidated or like discouraged, like, oh damn, like they're doing that. I never came up with that idea, like shame on me. But see it more as like, you know, like, oh shoot, that's a really cool idea. You know, like, what can I do?
I'm gonna steal that.
Yeah, what? I'm gonna take that idea, but I'm gonna make it better. I'm gonna do it my way, you know?
Flip it.
Yeah, you know, and I just think that's a really healthy approach that I wanna remind like our chat also to, like, when you see other people's work, like, it's like awesome. It's like, oh my God, I could have thought of that, you know? Yeah, don't have that discourage you. Have it be like, oh, someone else is doing that. I can do that too, you know?
It's like a template almost, I mean.
Yeah. Yeah,
you can learn a lot from it too. I mean, if you know, if you've never done it and then like you do it like a few times and it's like, okay, you get a better grasp of it.
Exactly. So
definitely
what's up, doggy?
Sorry.
No, you good?
Was that your spirit animal outside, dog?
Barnow.com.
No, that's interesting because, like, you know, There's originators, right? People that create original ideas, and there's the people that come second, right?
Like, yeah.
They do it better. So, for example, like MySpace to Facebook, or Yahoo to Google, right?
Right.
Like,
oh, yes.
I wish MySpace was still around.
Do you?
I know. My top eight.
I like it better than Facebook.
I was reading about how Tom was like the ideal, you know, person to run MySpace like that. Like, what happened to that kind of owner? You know, like Mark Zuckerberg is just completely
detached from his work. Yeah, he was on everyone's top eight. If you don't know how to change it, he's gonna teach you how to change it because he's gonna be up there. Like, what is it like?
That angle, though.
Yeah,
for we need to make that a. We need to name that Tom Angle.
Tom Angle. Oh damn.
Can you pull up his photo and put it as your virtual background real
quick? I'm on it.
Someone do it.
I'm on it.
Thank you, Don.
Don.
Thank you.
Facts.
But yeah, the poster zine idea we found online, and we thought it'd be a beautiful idea to just like blend the two. And we, of course, wanted to take the spirit of Nüfly, and we wanted to be interactive. So we knew for sure that we wanted people to do something with it, you know, not just like look at it. We didn't have what the idea was then, but it eventually became, we want people to write on this. And there it is. There's Tom.
There we go.
you gotta throw your back out.
Yeah, I know.
It's a very particular angle.
Oh, yeah. It is.
That's helping.
But yeah, the interactive part with the poster zine.
But I think we also wanted to approach it like, you know, if you were going through something, how do you want your friend to respond?
Yes.
You know, like, I think that this, we approach it like, you know, from the friend aspect.
We're your buddy. We're your homie.
Yes. because, you know.
That tied into the names of everything in the package. You know, fam, I'm going through it.
Right.
You got this. Yeah. You are not alone.
Yeah.
One day at a time.
Right.
Like, these mantras, you know, are very necessary in daily life, you know, to like kind of get through the day, mm-hmm. figure out what's going on. Mm-hmm. You know, mantras really help. That repetition. You
know? Agreed.
Facts.
And then for the third content, our mixes.
We're just music people.
Yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory. Music's a very big foundation for us. I think a lot of us use it as a primary source of healing. Whenever we kind of go through shit, you kind of pull up a very particular sound. It becomes
music
a symphony, yeah,
music
for your
is
mood.
It truly
energy.
Is.
It's a vibe.
It can change your feelings on something. If you
yes.
hear the right song at the right time,
yes.
you're going through something, you're like, oh fuck, that really expressed something that I need to hear at that moment to get through this.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
And then, Belinda reached out to your friends. You want to talk a little bit about that, Belinda? Just like the early stages of what you're telling them when you're reaching out to them, or maybe how you're deciding on who to reach out to?
I approached them with, you know, the whole purpose of our magazine is mental health and creativity, right?
Mm.
And ways that we navigate through that, how those two things are interconnected and it's part of the same DNA. So when I approached these four, I approached them because I feel like they're like the most soulful DJs that I know right now. And Isaiah was like a wild card.
Shout out to Isaiah.
People probably would not know who Isaiah is, but he's got a couple mixes that I've been listening to on rotation, like a lot. The two Regret Life Limit Pack, like that mix is super dope. It's like 13 minutes, but if you listen to it, like there are just certain skits and it just really expresses how I felt like on a daily, and I'll just be running that mix like all the time. It's on rotation for me. Isaiah's out in New York. I've never met him before. So when we do the contributor Zoom later at 2, it's going to be my first time seeing him.
Hey.
And his face and his voice and everything. But he's been like a huge supporter, man. He's been pulling up to all the chat rooms and like he'll be buying all the subs. And he's a really dope dude, man. And I really like
appreciate
his ear
you.
For music. So definitely appreciate Isaiah. Mm. And Miles, you know. Course, like I had to hit that guy up.
Just
he never gives people mixes, by the way. Apparently this is like the only mix he's ever given somebody to like release.
Whoa.
So we got the exclusive. I think he was on Sway in the Morning last year and that mix got taken down.
Oh, word. Oh,
SoundCloud, dude. Yeah,
Miles is he's a champion DJ.
He is a champion for
like
sure.
For real champion DJ, like
yes.
competition.
Oh, like quite literally.
Don't be pulling up to him at the competition. He'll smoke you. and like super
that.
Like monk like too. He's not the braggadocious type. He just be like, "What? I was just here with him. You know, like I just did my thing.
Like
did
my thing.
You know, yeah.
Light work.
Yes.
Love Miles. But yeah, I had to hit him up, and he turned in. Arguably one of the best mixes I've ever listened to. It felt very, you know, thought out and put a lot of time into it. And I feel like he caught the vibration just right.
We're actually on Miles' mix right now that's playing in the background.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Love the Forrest Gump little thing at the end too. for no particular reason, I just kept on going. And that just, represents Miles so well. Yeah, so shout out to Miles and Jody, also known as a roomie.
Jody.
Like, or are you one
cloud.
Of my top three
cloud.
Favorite female DJs ever. I just love her taste in music, and she just really knows how to pull some gems out. Like, you'd be like, yo, what? Like, usually if I'm listening to her play a set, I'm like, yo, what was that song? I need that edit. Send me some tracks, please. So I really fuck with Jody.
Mm-hmm.
And Lucci I met at a George Lopez special last year when I was working as assistant camera, and she played a couple sets. I was listening to it over the speakers. I was like, oh shit, who's this DJ? It's not just some generic top 40 stuff, but like I could tell that they dug up some goodies, and I was like getting some videos of her before I even met her. And then I pulled up into the booth like in between the two, because George Lopez had to do like two shows. I approached her and her girlfriend in the booth, and I was just like, hey, I really like your sound, like what's up, you know. And we just chatted, and then he found out that I shoot for Miles, and she was geeking out, and I was like, all right, well, it seems like we're on the same wavelength here, so let's figure out how to work together. She went back down to LA, and then I stopped by earlier this year to just say what up, and she and her girlfriend just like let me into their home. We just kicked it with their dog for a while. You know, I showed her some videos and just, you know, expressed interest in working together. And I just love her sound, man. Like, she's got that boom bop, like lo-fi, hip-hop, R&B, funk, soul, you know, thing going on. And it's the exact kind of DJ you'd want to hear if you like pulled up to her brunch, or if you pulled up to like, you know, late afternoon shindig. Yeah, it's got that vibe to it. So yeah, I hit her up. I felt like all four of these DJs, they're probably, you know, super wild cards. Like, who would ever thought to put them together? But I really see how their sounds interconnect, and I felt like it was a good combination. So yeah, that's why I put them up.
Yeah, I agree.
Well said.
Yeah, mixes were definitely, like, I think the cherry on top of like the whole care package were like, we tapped three senses for this care package, guys. That's pretty amazing for us. What are the other two that we're missing?
So we have scent, we have smell, information,
smell, tech, sight,
writing, writing exercise, because we figured that like writing stuff out and getting your thoughts out is a way of release as well.
Oh yeah, journaling is so important, dude.
Yeah. Facts. I need to get better on that.
Yeah. We all
might need to start doing some weekly journals.
I mean, we journal to each other by words. You know? We talk to each other.
Yeah. So. Well, I want to start a blog up. I think that'd be cool.
Nice.
Yeah.
Think yeah, of stuff about the post, sorry.
Go ahead.
That it's like, it's a poster zine, right? But, I mean, I don't want to spoil too much of the features, right? So you guys mentioned journaling, mm-hmm. and it's like, if you do that exercise first and then like say you like put the poster up, mm-hmm. and then, you know, maybe a couple of years go by and like, you know, your poster's just up, whatever, mm-hmm. and then you take it down, and then you could see, like, you can read your journal and you can be like, wow,
like, yeah, it's a little time capsule. There are layers to this care package.
Facts.
Like, this is why we'd be arguing until like 2 a.m.
Facts.
And that's probably gonna, it's probably gonna trip you out. It's probably gonna trip you the
it's
fuck out.
It's definitely gonna trip you out. It's definitely meant to trip you out, bro.
It's gonna be in, you're gonna have a journal piece from the worst time in history. I mean, not history, but I'm just saying, like, this crazy time that we're in right now, it's just like, that's where it's gonna be like, stem from, you know?
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. 2020, I think, is really forcing a lot of us into paying attention to things that are happening around us, because everyone's online now, basically, right? Everyone's online. You can't not know. But yeah.
Unless you're like Jared Leto and you went on a 10-day like silent meditation and you come back out, you're like, what
the world's burning.
Or like, there was like a group of people, they had like gotten a special ticket into the Grand Canyon, mm-hmm. and they were like just boating, like they were on a boat for like 21 days or something. They come out and they're like, what? We're in lockdown right now? What's happening? Like, they had a few hours on the car ride back to their house to kind of just like, whoa, I didn't realize, okay, we're stepping into the apocalypse right now. You know, like, what? Yeah, yeah. Who could have anticipated this? Everything's canceled? How?
Yeah. Well, it wasn't the case for us. Everyone's like, everyone's on Twitter, like, constantly, Instagram, we're all sharing, we're all like chatting with each other. So yeah, I definitely feel like it's, you know, a difficult time right now, but, you know, we're all going through it together. You know, we're here to help one another out, and our way of helping out some friends or people in our community is by putting together this care package, and it's out. Yeah. Available now. Nüfly.com. Okay, thank you guys.
And we out.
We're done talking. Mic dropped.
Yeah. Should we share some early concepts during right now, or should we do that for our second hour? Should we just maybe chat?
Wait till the second hour. Yeah.
Okay.
Just imagine if we didn't have internet during this time.
Dude, right. Speaking about that.
We wouldn't have been able to do this.
Talk about that dynamic.
Yeah, we're a whole ass, this care package was a whole ass success story of Zoom.
Yeah.
God damn it. I have so many memories of that all blend together of Don and I just being online on Zoom to 2 a.m. all those nights literally blended in together.
Your guys' Zoom level is you're on level 67 Zoom level.
we're farming now, bro. We're just farming.
Yeah.
Just grinding, bro.
Just grinding. Yeah.
Staying up late doing that. I don't think we really met up besides something that required us to physically be together. I think the only time we met up was in May when we did the candle packaging, right? Everything beforehand, when it came down to concept, when it came down to designs, when it came down to reviews, we all did that via Zoom. Dude, we even...
What a journey.
Yeah, we even completed a care package while we're doing these live sessions also. So I just want to give a big props to us also.
Yeah.
Weekly live streams. Weekly, guys.
Weekly live streams.
You do something every few weeks. That can seem stressful. We're doing this every week. So we can't even take a break from this.
This is session 26.
I'm exhausted.
Don't say we're stressed.
We love this shit.
I mean, that's why our thing is called fam. I'm going through it. We're all going through it. This is what we've been going through. These weekly live streams and this care package. Mm-hmm. That's already a lot. I ran into a friend while I was biking in my neighborhood, and I hadn't seen him in months. Mm-hmm. And he's like, "Yo, I've been watching your IG. You've been killing it." I'm like, "Dude, I can't even. This is all." And he's like, "Yeah, you seem like you're doing a lot. Do you relax? Do you take naps?" So I was like, "Yeah, I have to take naps, bro." Dude, Dan and I were talking about I was texting him earlier. We both woke up a little bit late because we were trying to build some backgrounds right for the stream, and. I was like, "Dude, I passed out with the lights on last night. The whole night I had lights on, bro. I passed out. I woke up at 5 and then he told me that he passed out with the lights on too at 2 a.m. I was like, "Fuck, how are we both passing out with the lights on? This is how exhausted we are." Dude,
we gotta get better on that for sure. Because
yeah. Do better.
I had not passed out with the lights up like that in a minute. I was like, "Damn, yeah. I must be fucked up right now. How did I?" I think I was trying to stay awake. I passed out from 10 p.m. until 12 a.m. last night. Mm-hmm. And then I woke back up because I was like, "Fuck, I gotta post at midnight to do that whole 12-hour algorithm thing on IG." And then I was like, I moved to my bed and I had the lights on. I thought, "Okay, if I kept my lights on, maybe I'll be able to stay up to post this before I pass out." But that didn't happen. Woke up at 5, was like, "I missed the time and I passed out with the lights on. I'm a fucking mess."
It's all good.
Hey, we still get shit done, man. I'm just telling you, it might look hella clean, but it's messy behind doors sometimes too. And we had to figure out how to get out of that mess. We had to figure out how to get our shit together, take a shower, how to put your clothes
on.
Remember
to take a shower.
Yo, taking a shower is important. I'm telling you, I'm endorsing that right now. Showers are important.
It's at least once a month.
Once a month, bro. What?
only the good parts.
Only the goods.
Yeah, only the goods, dude.
Damn.
But yeah, you gotta reset your body, you know?
Yeah. Big facts.
Take showers. Brought to you by taking showers.
Where's the text at, Don? Pull that up. Take showers.
What shower?
That's your job. You pull up signs in the back for your virtual PGs.
But dude, yeah, just reflecting on everything, like we I think Care Package 1 has kind of set as it was kind of an anchor point for some of us. Mm-hmm. You know, within the past 3 months, hella shit happened.
Hella.
It just kept getting worse and worse, bro. Yeah. Like every day
it started
you
wake at the
up
pandemic.
And you have this like terror, yeah. Like, right. Oh my God, what's going to be the new hashtag? Why is that person's name hashtag they die? Like, that's like the first thing I'm like, what's going on right now? Yeah. You know, like shit, this is crazy.
Yeah.
This is fucking crazy.
I think it was like really easy for us to kind of slip into, you know, not feeling motivated. But I think with our team being like very like active, you know, it kind of forced us to kind of push ourselves out of that rut. continue working, right?
Yeah, I think that goes back to like what Kent has said, like accountability and mm-hmm. like expectations, like mm-hmm. setting like roles for our team. I think that kind of set the tone for everything, right?
Yeah.
Like, we have more direction and also like we have a vision and kind of just like kind of slowly working towards it.
Right.
And it's funny because like Kent just said small projects, but it should take 4 months. it's just cool, but you know, we know now that we know how to work together and also like we know how to finish something. So mm-hmm. I think it's just going to get faster and faster. As
agreed.
Time goes.
Agreed.
So big shout outs to Kenta. If you need a business coach, hit him up.
Mm-hmm.
Kenta
mm-hmm.
Thomas on IG. He's expensive.
But his rates are worth it, man.
Pay the man his worth.
Pay his value.
I feel like with that, it's like you can't afford not to pay him. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
You know, you just gotta, sometimes you just need direction from people that are a little bit more experienced too. Like mm-hmm. Yeah, it might be a little bit out of your bank, but it's an investment,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Right.
So it's definitely valuable.
I feel that.
Yeah.
Big facts, man.
Go ahead.
Oh, I was gonna say, can we have like a moment where maybe we go like with a round table and just maybe talk about how you, like any immediate memories that come back and like how you feel about like us completing this project right now? Maybe we start
You go first.
Me?
Yeah. You're like trying to set yourself up right now. You're
no,
like,
you about to unload on him?
Ask myself a question right now.
Okay, I'll start. I think from my end, first and foremost, big shout out to Wildflower House. That's Gina and Hana. Mango
and Puma.
Hey. They have Puma. Been very patient with me. With spending a lot of hours on this project, they're always there to listen to me vent. they're always there to, you know, just help me kind of see through the lines. Even when it came down to like the later stages of this project, when we were designing like the spread, the launch spreads, I was really in a rut because I couldn't figure out, or I wasn't creating anything that I liked. I specifically recount Gina just mentioning like, don't you guys always review this together? You know, like, why are you working on it by yourself? Why isn't Don looking at this? Why isn't Belinda looking at this? Like, what are you doing? You know, and I'm just like, you're right. You know, you're right. And then so I reached out to Don, and then even Don like gave me some clarity at that moment. Like, dude, like this text is cool, but no one's gonna read anything on the launch spread. Don't forget we have like caption space. All of these little factors that kind of like helped me navigate through like whatever my task was at that given time. So big shout out to Wildflower. Big shout out.
I think it's because we have like certain habits, you know, where we're like we have to depend on ourselves and like usually work by yourself, right? So you're not usually talking to us when you're working on Eden work,
right?
So you're just kind of in that like pattern of thought that like, oh, I can't talk to anybody. I feel that way too when I'm working on videos, when I'm working on certain things,
mm-hmm.
and even when I was like that's why I had that meltdown last week of OBS, because I've been like fucking dealing with that all week. And I just was like, Dan, I need help. Can you just take over next week, please? Because my laptop obviously cannot handle it. And I'm trying really hard, but it's not working.
Yeah.
I have to like just turn my ego down. Like, just please do it. Like, yeah. For now, you know, until I can figure it out.
Nah, for real. I think we, with our team, you know, like, I'm just happy that I can openly talk to you guys, like, really easily. Even if it's not work-related, I usually, like, text Kaz on the side when, like, I'm interested in some, like, particular clothes, just get his thoughts on it. But all in all, like, this team... I just really appreciate that you guys trust me also with some of the work too. I know, like, sometimes I spearhead some things first and it's kind of like, I don't know where this is going until I put some time and then I could share it with you guys and then you guys help sharpen, like, what the idea was. Yeah, a lot of restless nights. I did have a lot of fun with this. I think this is a really big learning experience with us. I love that we approach a lot of projects with confidence. I think for a lot of these things, like, sometimes it is our first thing or our first time doing something, whether it be like packaging or like design, like ordering stickers. I've never ordered stickers before personally or designed for a sticker. But we all brought together some, like, experiences, like for, like, printing, you know, I had some experience with that based off the prior, gigs with Eden. I just love how, you know, there was never really a time where we said, we don't know how to do that. It was either, maybe that's not a good idea for this project, or it would be like, this is what we need to do to get it done. So shout out to the team. I had a lot of fun doing this and thank you guys for trusting me.
Thank you.
Ah, thank you, dude.
Dan, you killed it.
Oh man, team effort. Couldn't have done it without you guys, honestly.
You just go hurt yourself, patting yourself on the back right now. I well deserved.
We're idiots.
Oh my god. All right, someone else take
that's why we're with each other.
Yeah,
I handpicked you guys for a reason.
I'll go next. Like, you know, when we first started this project in Fly, like, I had no faith in our project. I'm gonna be real with y'all. Like, it was back in the day when we were at
over
a year ago, Phil's Coffee on Ocean, and we're just going there. And it's like, fuck, I don't want to go on my Saturday. Like, I want to have fun. But I slowly but surely, I kept going, started talking ideas. We need a logo. You know,
Dan and I spent so many afternoons at that film. So many afternoons. And like, you know, we would be in there for like a good 6 to 7 hours, like until they close, bro. Like,
but in Don's defense, it was like our project that we had the vision on, and I remember like when Don was coming in, he was like, so what do you guys have to show me? It's like, oh, we don't have anything, dude.
we just have ideas. Yeah. And I remember like me knowing Belinda, this is before I met you, Dan. And B was like, yo, I have this project going on, da, da, da. I want you to be a part of it. I was like, I don't know, B, like, I've worked with you before. Like, like, try to do your logo, that shit took forever. Like, it's just, I already knew, you know? And I was like, okay, fuck it, I'll just try it. And yeah, everything just, you know, kept going. We pushed forward. I had this idea of like, let's get an office.
Yeah, that was your idea, bro.
That was your idea, though. That was your
shout
idea.
Out to you and this office.
I think Belinda loves it the most.
Let go of right now.
Yeah. But I think that...
You know what? I see value in keeping this right now, all right?
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Like, I just reset the whiteboard. Like, dude, I feel so much better. This is my whole strategy in the background now. None of y'all can read this, but I got post-it notes. I got shit. Like, I've been checking shit off. I'm getting shit done right now.
Screenshot,
I just moved
in.
The calendar over here, too. Yeah. Like, but I moved the calendar over here right next to the fucking whiteboard so I can keep track and have deadlines. And I'm going to get deadlines going. We're gonna get deadlines done.
Hell yeah.
That's
a lot better than having on the other wall.
It's way better. I was walking like, why back and is forth. It next to the door, bro?
The sink.
Like, the fuck?
Were you throwing away trash?
Like, wait, why? I'm like looking at the whiteboard.
Oh, today's Tuesday?
Looking over at the calendar. I'm like, why is it all the way over there? I just moved it over. I was like, it just makes sense. Like, yeah. Dummy.
I think getting the office definitely changed our like motive.
Yeah. I don't think Don was like ready for me to just be like, yeah, we're doing this right now. He was like, wait, what? I thought
I just threw it out there. Well, the next thing I know, we're citing papers.
You cannot just tell me an idea. Like, yo, if I feel the idea, I'm like all in. There's no argument at all.
I feel like collectively y'all like escalated it
pretty fast. Yeah.
like oh, let's like Don brought it up and then we saw it.
I can't let good ideas die. Like, I gotta go and like manifest it as much as I can.
I think that just changed the seriousness of the whole project, right? Like, we were actually investing in something, using our own money, and it's like...
I just know you were tired of bumping elbows with people and being like, who the fuck is this person next to me? They're stealing my secrets. They're gonna follow, they're gonna, screenshot everything. I'm like, what the fuck?
On my juice.
Because sometimes we wouldn't be able to get a table at Phil's, and we would have to sit at the group long table, just sharing a huge table with four other people.
Right. Yeah, trying to find an outlet to charge my laptop.
And he's just looking at me what the fuck are we doing in here? I can't.
And that's the origin story. Yeah, that was tight. And look how
very candid.
Yeah, look how far we came now, right? You're still at it.
I see Gina just put up all your dead emo.
Very pleased with all the
I'm putting some aliens in here real fast.
But yeah, I think it was cool how we navigated together, as a team. Definitely we grew a lot, and I think we learned a lot from this project that we finished. And just, it feels so good just saying we finished, right? We released, and then it was a long time coming. There's a lot of countless days and arguments and discussions that we all went through, and it's like Belinda being like, this isn't aligned, the color's not right, you know,
misspelled exercise.
Can we see this one in light pink?
We're live editing things, there's no revision.
Dan and I are text arguing over a comma, that's how detail oriented we are. We fight over
pains.
Commas
it's
and hyphens
pains. Yeah. But now we know, right? That just makes us better as a team, and I think I'm so grateful for that. It's dope.
It's good that we can get past arguments. That shows that we can.
Yeah,
for sure.
Especially us being all lone wolves, right? We all freelance on our own, and collaborating, that's such a hard thing to do with everybody that's so set in their ways, right?
That's true, too.
It's a gem to have this team, right? I'm very grateful to y'all.
Hey.
Y'all are the sauce, man. Y'all are the sauce.
Hey, can I jump in real quick? Yeah, I just want to, basically jumping off that idea, I'm super grateful to be part of it's coming into a community too, where, I'm the biggest lone wolf, you know, I'm I'm the fucking wolf, you know? So for me,
I am too. That's how I feel you, dude.
At the same time, I'm super grateful because all of us still have our, grinds that we do,
right,
to actually make money and stuff like that. This is not our full-time thing. I mean, it is in our hearts, but it's you still got to do shit to pay the bills and stuff. Mm-hmm. And if it was our 100% thing, it would have been who knows what it would be.
I think we're getting there. I think we're slowly getting there, dude. I honestly feel that way.
But I think it's important because it's it's building a community. You know, because it starts with the four of us. I mean, I'm gonna be honest, everyone has their effort is, it's not the same. Mm. You know, the origin story goes back to Belinda and Dan. You know, that's always gonna be their baby and stuff. So it's we can contribute what we can contribute, right? Mm. And so it's also mad interesting working with a team, because it's there's always a dynamic to it, because it's when you work by yourself, you have your own process or whatever. Mm-hmm. But when it's four people, there's a whole different way of operating. Mm-hmm. So you have to account for people's thoughts, opinions and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And it's never going to be yours, because it's however many people it is, you know? Mm-hmm. Agreed. And so you gotta figure out, it's if you don't practice, you're never gonna figure it out. So imagine I always do sports analogies. I'm that sports fucking guy. But I mean, it's if you play out on a team, say you're a basketball team and you guys never practiced before, mm-hmm. and y'all go to the game and stuff, it's
Yeah, of course we're not going to be perfect and yeah. You know,
because I mean that's what we try to be perfect, you know, for ourselves and stuff like that, like mm-hmm. when we come to our, like our shit especially. But I mean, like working with the team is a totally different story, you know. And I mean, for me personally, you know, I just wanted to try to contribute something like super focused. I mean, there's a lot of stuff that we all can do. Like we all can do graphic design. Mm-hmm. A lot of us can do video, and it's just like, but you know, we all have our specialties too. So for me, I mean, I could, you know, like Dan and Don Belinda spent a lot of time on the graphic, you know, and I was there for meetings to like put in input every now and then, but you know, they really like got down on that shit. And then there, I mean, a lot of the conceptual stuff, you know, was all of us, mm-hmm. you know, like, you know, just bouncing off, like having pretty much just kind of discussions like, oh, you know, how are we feeling? Like what's like the, what brings us like calmness or whatever, you know, like different, you know, things that we do. Mm-hmm. And that kind of came up, that manifested this project and stuff. And for me, it's just like, I'm just super grateful to be part of a team and a community that we're building. And it, you know, it's definitely only up from here, because it's like, yeah, it's seemed longer, but yeah, I mean, the first stages are always going to be like painful, you know?
It's going to be rough, you know?
Yeah, like it's going to be super painful.
Yeah.
But then it's like, you know, it's like when you build the machine or the car or whatever, and it gets going, and fuck, it gets going. Next thing you know, we bulldoze through this thing. So,
red line.
Dude, I just like started and finished watching The Last Dance last week, and I'm like so motivated now after watching Jordan just
Bro,
like.
The last.
Why do you think I always do sports analogies? Mm-hmm. Because, I mean, not everyone's a sports person, but there's a lot of like inspiration there too.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know,
dude,
so.
Dude, like that man is crazy. Can you imagine just like stopping in the middle of the career and like being like, I'm gonna do Major League Baseball, guys. Like, I'm gonna do this for a year. And like he completely redid his whole body, because it's different when you play baseball, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Everything's more in the chest and the arms area. And
how many episodes have you seen?
I watched all of them. Like,
oh shit.
I binge watched all 10 episodes last week.
Damn.
On NBA, on their website. Like,
is it free?
No,
I haven't seen him yet. I haven't seen it yet.
It's for free, man. It's for free.
Oh, shit.
All the episodes are up there, but I think Netflix is about to release it too. I was like, God damn it, why didn't I just wait for Netflix? Because like,
ooh, I'm about
with,
to peek
like,
that.
With their site, I had to like go back to the page of all the episode links and then like kind of keep like opening it up to watch it. But it was so worth it, man. Like his work ethic is crazy.
How long are the episodes?
Like hour long episodes. Like I watched like probably 10 hours of it. Like now I'm just fucking pumped. Like
10 hours of Michael Jordan.
Ready to go. Because he's a marathon man. Like it's crazy, dude. Like his trajectory and like
dude,
what he did.
He had passion.
I had no idea all the strategies and everything he had to do to make all that happen. You know,
it's kind of a psychopath.
Totally. Totally.
It's
you know,
kind of a psychopath.
A little bit, but you know, what? I had professors that had that exact same personality that whipped me into shape. Like, I can't help it. Like, I don't know how to be nice, so I've been learning how to like talk nicer. But I had really tough teachers growing up, man. Like, they had that exact same kind of work ethic. So, like, watching that in Jordan, like, I'm like, and then also watching my mom's work ethic too. I'm like, okay, I understand why I'm like this and like why I connect with that kind of work ethic so much and how he approached it. But yeah, I highly recommend it. Like, Last Dance killed it. Mm. Did a lot, and like the music selection too, and just the
was it very 90s?
I thought that they did a good job. It was kind of 90s. It was dope, dude. I didn't realize like Jordan was like the first basketball guy to go into shoes. You know, like the whole Jordan line. Like he's not really a Nike fan to begin with. Like his agent had to force him into that meeting with Nike. I think he was like a Converse fan or Adidas, I don't remember, but he just was like, all right.
And Nike, when they got Michael Jordan, kind of changed a lot of things for them too. Culturally.
Oh yeah, for sure,
yeah,
for sure.
Culturally.
Yeah,
because Nike was always for a while the underdog. Actually, like they were not as known, and so what they did, mm-hmm. I spent a lot of money towards marketing and finding people like Michael Jordan. Shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think Jordan's agent before. He got Jordan. He had like some tennis stars, and like one guy is like a black tennis player. He got him on commercials and all this stuff. And I was like, wow, I didn't know all this stuff was going on. Like, because you had to really treat it like a business too, because you can blow all that money hella fast if you don't think about investments, if you don't think about your future, about equity, and all this stuff. Yeah, so it was really dope to just watch that, you know.
Thanks. Before we transition into the process, Belinda, do you have any last thoughts on just looking back at this and our entire project? Any specific things you want to shout out?
This is step one. We got a long way to go. I'm really, really happy that we finished this. This is like blood, sweat, and tears, man, like for real. So yeah, I'm just happy that, you know, I knew that this was gonna happen because I really believe in you guys and I believe in us and I believe in what we're trying to do. And so I think, yeah, our intentions were just right. And I know, yeah, like your intentions are so important. And I really feel like the universe heard us and is providing, you know. Yeah, so I'm just really proud of us and can't wait to do more. Can't wait for what's next.
Do more.
Speaking about that, I feel like a lot of people want to help one another, but no one's just asking for help. So by us reaching out to people and saying we need help, you know, people were so quick and so willing, you know, to like, yeah, I want to get involved, I want to help out. So if there's something our like chat can take away too, like, be comfortable with asking people when you need help, you know, because I think odds are usually like more so than often in your favor that people are just kind of like, yeah, I want to help out, but I don't know who needs the help. So when you reach out to that someone specific and you know, stars align, like they're gonna help you get you what you need at that time.
Yeah, it makes both parties feel good.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah,
I think all of us, like human condition, it's like we want to build community, we want to help people, and that's how we feel good, right? Like right. Giving gifts to people, it's like right. It's not just you spending money, it's like I want to better your life.
Yeah,
and that helps.
I think we're givers for sure. I'm definitely a giver.
Same.
Facts.
Yeah, and yeah, like don't, like Dan said, don't be afraid to ask for help because they're your homies at the end of the day, right? And even though they're strangers, they will help you too, right? They'll see your intention, they'll see your vibe, whatever. So,
like your success is their success also, because exactly. At the end of the day, it's like, oh, I know that person, you know, like
right,
yeah,
right.
Yeah. No, that's exactly.
I do know.
You do know. Nice. Okay, let's go ahead and transition us. I have a couple things pulled up from our shared drive. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of those. I think this one would be a great place for us to start. Where is it? Okay, here we go. All right. This, I think, was the first thing we all came together and talked about, right? This was a concept stage. We knew we definitely wanted to run a campaign. Here's all some of our ideas of like, oh, the QR code will give you like a link to a private playlist. We knew we wanted candles. Here's like Kaz and Belinda like are mentioning about the motion graphic. Belinda, you know, looking for the DJs. And then me and Don getting the candle and poster zine together. This sounds all super easy until you actually start doing it. My God, this is literally our care package, but it's in bullet point form. And I'm like, yeah, this is easy. Let's do it. little did we know.
Yeah.
A
lot of logistical stuff.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
Small stuff, but it adds up. Right.
Yeah. Literally
finding scents, finding you know, finding people that make stuff, print stuff,
yes,
DJ stuff. It's yeah,
yes. Here were some of our bullet points of why, you know, here's our mention again that we wanted to do a smaller project and completing a smaller project together as a team. And you know, as a young brand ourselves, we need operating funds as well. So we wanted this small project to be something that can fund our efforts as well. So thank you for everyone so far who has purchased everything you are doing. We are literally reinvesting it into Nüfly, to whether it be like keeping our website a flow,
more content,
that we just merch. Spent 420 on.
Exactly.
Yo, but I've been getting compliments about our store though. People are like wondering how, like what we're using. Does it seem easy to
direct,
check out?
Direct them to Don.
So
man.
Shout out to Don.
Big shout out to Don. He
that
literally
makes me feel good.
He literally spearheaded the entire website.
He had to fight
website.
Us to use Webflow.
Yeah.
Or oh. me specifically.
So here's our why. I think going forward with any project, these three pillars are very important. You know, you start with your why, so everyone has that foundation. You can talk about how you're going to do it, you know, because that it starts exploring the actualizations of your whys. And then by identifying the what, you know, allows your team to focus on what needs to be done. So how we're going to do it, you know, we wanted to specifically talk about a subject that's related to mental health. We care a lot about our community's well-being, and in addition to our own well-beings. We wanted to provide, you know, a care package that would support people in our industry, or even people who like art, you know, who like being very intentional, or, you know, people who like experiences. You know, this whole care package is literally an entire experience. So that led us to what our what's, and that was a candle, poster zine, and the playlist. So I'm just reading this. The goal of this campaign is to support individuals who are experiencing anxiety at home and provide relief for an artist who stepped up to the front lines in regards to the coronavirus. We stayed on track, guys. I'm very proud of us.
Yeah.
There's nothing I'm reading here that was like, oh, that was an old idea. So here are some of the narratives that we're trying to, like, when we're talking with one another, it's like, oh, you know, like, what's causing the anxiety? You know, COVID's making us, like, be very concerned about our rent. And some of us have to be home right now they're forced to be home with our siblings, you know, so that can cause some stress for some people too. I think someone's doing my neighbor's doing some construction, if you guys hear knocking. Moving forward.
Let's build, fam.
Let's build. Yo, hey, this comment is on March 31st, guys.
Dang.
We have receipts. So we need a poster size, it's gonna be 18 by 24. So here is our concept stages. You know, we had like, we definitely knew the poster wanted to have a message. Here are some of the earlier ideas, like you are not alone, stop reminiscing and move forward, it's all gonna be okay. A quote by Mandy Hale saying, learn to be alone and to like it. There's nothing more freeing and empowering than learning to like your own company.
Hmm.
Wow.
Who wrote that down?
I don't know, but I like it. We had the idea of like user fills in the blank, you know, like, and we just prompt them with a question. So the early idea for the zine were page one being the cover page two an introduction to anxiety, what it means, something to frame what we're trying to talk about, and page three being an exercise, like using the candle, using the QR code, page four being interactive, things to do physically with the candle or QR code. Damn, we nailed this, guy. We literally did everything we said we were gonna do. Cool.
Shout out to us.
Yeah, big
shout out to us. Gang.
I don't know what we did to do next, but we ended up, like, I'm just gonna speak from my end, like Don and I ended up working on a candle label first, because I think what was happening was that we were we at this point knew the mission, and then everyone kind of set off to take care of what they needed to do, right? For example, like Belinda at that time reached out to Natalie. She was also reaching out to the DJs. Kaz was at this time beginning the early stages of the motion graphic. And for Don and I, we did the candle first. Hair.
Oh boy.
Hair are super early stages of what we thought, like. Shout out to Envision also. We highly recommend this free to use software. You just basically sign up for an account on Envision. And what's great about this is that you can have these collaborative art boards. that we would highly recommend any newer team or any team that has a lot of moving parts and you guys all need to be on the same page with the vision. This software helps a lot. Okay, I'm trying to look for where we started. Is it here?
I think we started on the right side where the candle is. We decided on which candle we wanted first.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So this is like Natalie's work, right?
Yeah. She sent us an early kind of like deck showing her examples of candles that she has previously created. So we all centered around like this one. And as you can see, it reflects in the final product. So. More props.
More props. I think
we're gonna hurt ourselves.
Yeah. I think above that, we were kind of thinking about like ideas on like the whole experience when you open the package, right?
Right.
Like,
right.
Why are we lighting the candle in case of an emergency? This is just one of the ideas that we had.
Early stages.
Like naming.
In case of a mental emergency.
Yeah.
Ooh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think it was like we're having a discussion about like should we name the candle like a name, you know, mm-hmm. or should we just have something like a quote? Mm-hmm. Like we had this like back and forth for a couple days. I feel like
We did. but I remember this stage too.
Who sketched that out, or is that a picture?
This was a sketch. I did it in InVision. Oh. So
nice.
I really recommend InVision. Like you get this pencil app. As long as you have a Wacom tablet, you can draw like literally anything.
Or mouse.
Get yourself a tablet, guys.
Nah, mouse is fun. I've been using a mouse.
You need a tablet endorsement on top of the yerba.
Hey. Yeah.
So hey, shout out to yerba.
Shout out to yerba. Yerba, we're coming for you next.
We're plugging.
Yerba mate, sponsor us. We love your product. Anywho, so here were some early stages of how we're thinking about where the label can exist. I remember Don had this really cool idea that he posted. Yeah, this one. He shared this image, which is, you could see the callouts for this, where that stickers bleed over edges of the package. And that kind of like helped inspire us for like the early kind of like ideas where we wanted the label to be. But I think we ran into some issues with the form factor. Like we couldn't figure out, like if we split this in half, like do we either design something that's intentionally split in half, where we have like maybe our logo right here, and then like on like this side we'll have like all the copy. I don't know. We ended up choosing, if we ended up going back to the experience, right? We want to be very specific about the experience of someone opening this. So what better way to have that label be right under the lid facing you as soon as you open the box? So we ended up drafting up these ideas of, okay, like the label will be in there and it'll be the first thing you read. And some early concepts for this on how I got it like that, I'm gonna go to Behance. Behance, if you don't know, is pretty much like a online designer showcase, whether it be like photography, products or whatnot. I use this a lot. I highly recommend people to, because you can save projects and they're great for like referencing, you know. You don't always have to reinvent the wheel when it comes to design. I was just looking for faster ways to get idea and borrow elements and kind of put it together into ours. So I think that I hope I saved it. It was a Nike project. It was a Nike project that they created a label. I can't find it. Oh, it was a Nike label that had this kind of 5x4 rectangle layout, and it just had like sectioned areas with text going down. And what I took away a lot from it was A, keep it simple, but B, use contrast and text to help the reader kind of glide through whatever you're showing them easily. So the main things I wanted to call out were, you know, the categories, like the scent, the date, who it was made by, the batch number. I think this batch number idea came, it just made a lot of sense personally for us. You know, when we purchase things and it comes in a limited quantity, it just raises the value when you see like, oh, I got number 46 out of like 500. Ooh. You know, like we're borrowing a lot of our personal experiences to put into this project, and I think that makes this project a lot more us. You know, we're just collectively us. So yeah, I'm gonna bring us over to Illustrator. Like, so we have the idea now, let's go ahead and build it.
Just show the deck.
The deck. Oh wait, the deck happened after, right? Like, yeah, we decided on the name.
Oh right.
Well, not name, but we decided on what the message was gonna be, which is a whole story itself.
Yeah, just
that was probably our first fight.
Yes.
Yes. It wasn't a fight. It was war.
It was war.
It was first battle.
Kaz was like, "Hey, let me know when you guys finish, man." I'm.
Kaz was like, "I'm Switzerland here. Like, y'all just
like, I don't want to deal with you guys.
I like everything."
Facts. Where is this? Not candle deck. Is it this one? Candle level rectangle.
You can also show what you guys did for Natalie too after.
Yeah. We could share the deck. Oh, this is it. All right. This is our working file for everything for the candle label related. I think it started at first with the copy that we made first. I think it's very important to have the customer know the detail about what product they're about to experience. So by us just talking about giving a little backstory about the candle, letting people know that it was handmade and that it was hand poured by Natalie, and that it can be repurposed because the way Natalie made them, she actually put in a white gloss glaze inside there to make the cup, I guess, like you can drink out of it pretty much. It's clean enough for you to drink out of it after it all burns out and you take off the wick. So the variable at this point was, what were we gonna name this candle? If it even needed a name for this candle, we had things like, I don't remember why we put adjust. We had ideas like reclaim. We had a different layout idea for this, which I thought was really cool too. Kind of gives me like a Pantone swatch kind of color vibe. And it's funny because here's lavender. We didn't use lavender again until the launch spread, and lavender became a very prominent kind of color for this project for some reason, now that I'm looking at it. I also want to note and give a specific shout to Don for helping me with Illustrator. I think during these stages, I was like still very like boo-boo new to Illustrator.
Young Jedi.
Yeah, and it's for anyone who's Photoshop only listening to right now, like Illustrator is really dope for the amount of real estate you get. You see all these like thrown away ideas, like we can always refer back to them if we need them.
You can basically have your mood board up there.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, you really can. You can't do that in Photoshop. You're restricted to whatever like the canvas shows you. And now going back to Photoshop, I feel the limitations. So if you needed someone to remind you to check out Illustrator, here.
Hit me up.
Yeah, I'll hit up Don.
Have you tried that artboard feature on Photoshop though now?
It's like a new feature. I have. It's interesting, but it doesn't work as quickly in my opinion. Or
yeah, Illustrator's just hella like, Illustrator is super fast.
Yeah, exactly.
That vector.
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 Okay. I think now we basically agreed on the layout, and we were at this point of deciding on what message, title, name, thing we wanted to put onto this care package. Belinda, how about you share with us that story?
Okay. I think you guys were swinging hard for reclaim, and not feeling the name at all. I understood the reason, like what the intention was with using the word reclaim, but I just didn't really like it. And I think I was on a bit of a rush that day too when we got off the stream and we were talking about it. And it was a learning lesson for me, you know. I got to be a better leader. I got to be better at communicating and figuring out solutions. But yeah, we're just not on the same page with it. I think I was fighting for like adjust. I like that better. But I realized like we had to figure out some kind of compromise. So I kind of just reapproached the whole name of it. Like, does it have to be an official sounding name? Does it have to be, you know, something that had that many layers to it? Or maybe we can approach it from, you know, what would you want to hear from your friend if they were telling you, fam, I'm going through it, you know? Mm-hmm. What would you want to hear? Mm-hmm. And I was thinking like, oh, you know, like maybe you'll be okay. So I remember I called Dan a couple hours after got off the Zoom, and I was like, all right, you know, I think we need to come up with something better. And like, what about like, you'll be okay, you know? So I'll hear that from my friends sometimes. Like, you'll be okay, like, you're fine, mm-hmm. be okay. But he kind of took it to the next level and was like, how about you got this? I feel like that's a lot more empowering.
Watch out, miss.
I can stand for that a lot better. And I was like, all right, actually, that is a lot better. I would feel better if I heard you got this.
Mm. Can I just add in?
Yeah.
So just mind you, this was like days after going back and forth. And at that point, I was just like over it. Like, you guys figure out the name and we'll just go.
Basically.
No, it was pretty. It was not a couple of days. It was like that stream that I had to do.
Yeah.
When I was editing, and then I remember I went off to the baseball field near my house. I was just getting some air. I ended up calling Dan. I was like, I don't feel good about how I ended that call, because I know that I was rushing it, because I was trying to like, because I was shooting something. I was shooting that like month long series thing on IG, and I had to like. The sun was going down. I was not in the right mind space to like talk about it. I didn't realize we were trying to have a meeting after I had like just did that 3-hour long live stream. So I was burnt out and was just not really communicating very well. Mm-hmm. So I was checked out. And then I had to call Dan like a couple hours after. I was like, hey, we need to figure this out. And I told him about the whole like you'll be okay thing, and then he said you got this instead. So I was like, all right. And we ended up doing a Zoom call the next day. I think I called you, Don, beforehand. We were just like talking it out, and then we talked to Riza right after.
Yeah, debrief for remember. The next week.
Many, like,
I'm just letting you know that that's what happened.
Yeah.
Basically, yeah. And so if anything, what we learned from that our takeaway was, if you have something going on and you can't work at this time, communicate it to the team. Because
oh yeah, that's what Dan was telling me too. He was like, you should approach it more like Kaz. Like, Kaz knows how to get the fuck out of the room without like getting anybody angry.
Basically, I was like, you see how Kaz just kind of says like,
he doesn't tell you what he's gotta do. Right, yeah. He just tells you I got to do something and just be vague. Like, you can be vague and just communicate that. I was like, fuck, you're right.
It's like, we're all busy people, you know? And when we work with one another, I think it's like, you should be like willing to work, you know? If you have something else going on, like, we're all understanding people, you know? It's like, oh, of course, like, take care of what you need to too. So I was telling like Belinda, like, just the way like how Kaz kind of like is very capable of just like communicating like what
he knows how to Homer Simpson into the bush.
No, he's really good at communicating what's on his plate. like I'm not available right now, I can't make this, and like that's totally fine, you know.
Yeah,
because what happened was that you had something you had to do, but then you didn't tell that to us. So then the whole time we were working on this, you were becoming more and more frustrated because you were not able to attend to the thing that you needed to take care of at that time.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Can I add to that too?
Yeah, yeah, please.
I mean, that was like something we talked. I feel like, I don't know if anyone tuned into like way earlier streams and stuff like that. Like, cause we're on stream 26 already. So that's almost half a year. But like, yeah, that was like one thing I was trying to work on when it came to communicating, you know, what's on my plate, you know, cause we, you know, at the same time, we're only humans. So we can only really get so much. We have our own, things that we need to get done just Facts. For family, work. And, you know, just, you know, for our partners and our friends and stuff. So it's like, you know, like that's the hard part about being like an artist too, is because like, when do you find that time to like actually like, you know, develop and work on stuff too.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I mean, that was one thing I was trying to get better at, you know, and I just got to be transparent sometimes too. And it's like, but I mean, at the same time, you know, like I trust in everyone in this team, I trust. So I don't really want to like second guess anybody either, you know, cause, and so it's like, that's why I want, like, for me, it's like, I always want to like, I just want to know what's on my plate so I can at least try to get that done and not have to worry about like the extra stuff. Cause I just want to be able to do my part, 100%.
Facts.
While balancing, while juggling, you know, the other stuff, the necessary stuff in life, like we got to do and shit.
Big facts.
And then I think it helped a lot to, yeah. Like if Belinda, if you're being stressed about that, it's like, yeah, just be honest. And if you need like you know, extra time or something like that to square out some stuff, then the shit's gonna get done. That's why you have a team.
Yes.
Yeah.
There it is.
You know, like you don't have to like, because that's, you know, we're all lone wolves too, for sure. And so it's like we're used to taking the project from 0 to 100, literally, you know.
Yeah, it's really hard. Yeah, that's another thing too, with the whole lone wolf thing. I'm not used to asking for help. I think I also like picked this up from my mom too, that I've noticed, like behaviorally, like my mom does not ask for help like that either. So I think I like just carried on that like behavioral pattern, you know. If I'm trying to get better at it, I'm trying to get better at asking for help and communicating with my mom.
It's all good. We're all learning, you know.
Yes.
Yeah.
Facts.
I think progress is being made. I hope.
No, we are.
What is that squiggly thing?
I don't know. I think we're playing with some effects.
That's some abstract organic. Yeah.
We also knew that in addition to the label inside, we should have a tamper resistant sticker. That was more of my suggestion. I like tamper resistant things because A, there's an opportunity for branding, but B, it's experience, right? When you get that candle and there's a sticker on it, you know no one messed with it, to the point of it being packaged together. So here are some like early layouts. I think the clear cut winner was the first one, mainly because of the price. I think the first idea we wanted was this translucent one, but there's a deal going on a sticker mill that was not for translucent stickers, so we ended up choosing this white one. So with that, so with all the
arguments, it's legible.
Yeah, and it's legible. Shout out to legibility. So through all that deciding process, through all of us learning, we eventually printed out the labels. And then while it was getting printed, we wanted to update Natalie too on how the candle is gonna be put together. So I'm just gonna quickly go through this deck. This is just what we shared with her. You know, we were talking about like our intention, like, hey, this label is designed and intended to, you know, complement the candle vessels produced by Natalie. And its goal were to communicate the details of the candle, complement the poster zine design, and be easily understood by the user. So first label, the tamper resistant, you know, 3x3 sticker, and here is how it would look like on the texture. And then here's label 2, a friend rooting you on.
Dang.
Killed this deck, dude.
Dang.
The second label is a 2x3 rectangle sticker revealing an encouraging message and the candle's detail under the box's opening lid. A batch number of blank blank out of 50 will be handwritten by us, which it was. So here it is behind the texture, and here are the mock-ups. I am super proud that these mock-ups look literally exactly like
how it looks. No, they literally look exactly like...
It looks exactly like that. And we did this in Photoshop.
Hey.
Y'all killed it.
Yeah.
Okay, so, you know, give it to Natalie. Natalie loved it. We went ahead and proceeded. I want to be mindful of our time.
Yeah,
we got 25 minutes right now. Okay. Guys.
Can I alley-oop this to Kaz so he can talk about the motion graphic, and then we could bring it to Belinda, and then we bring it to Don, and if there's enough time, we could come back to me.
I'm not gonna spend a lot. Like, I'll show it, and we'll talk about it too.
Sure.
Since we're short on time too.
Yeah.
We were just bringing it back to you know, use and the function of what we're trying to do. Let me share my screen real quick,
please.
Where's my After Effects? Why is my After Effects not showing up? Hold up. Oh shit, it's not open. Can you see After Effects?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, so I mean, I know we spent a little bit of time on, like, you know, another stream looking at this too. Mm-hmm. But, you know, with us, you know, it's really crucial to kind of like calm your, when you're going through like anxiety and stuff like that, you know, sometimes your heart's racing and, you know, it's a really like, you know, adding like extra to the, that feeling of like being like stressed out and anxious and stuff like that. So breathing is especially important when it comes to calming that down. And so, you know, the method of Mattis was 4-7-8 breathing, which, you know, like with the 4 breaths in, it's pretty normal, but then 7 is a little bit like holding it. It's a little bit longer breath than you're used to, because sometimes it's just your breath's just like kind of short and stuff. And especially well, everybody's different when they breathe too, but I mean, it's definitely, you know, we definitely wanted to, you know, you thought about the color, and I mean, I think the color kind of complements the poster zine too, because it's like, I think we pretty much use a similar color palette, right? Pretty similar.
Yeah, basically.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, this one's kind of like more, you know, obviously digital and on the phone through mobile and stuff, so it's a totally different experience. And that was one thing I was looking of thinking of too, and a lot of stuff that we kind of contemplated when we were doing, like when we were taking a look at this through like revisions and stuff like that. And all the revisions were very I think subtle. They're not like, you know, super crazy, like you would think super crazy changes to it, but it does actually help to the function of it when it came to like etching out a voice and everything between giving instruction and simplicity, where it's not just like too wordy or something like that, you know?
Right.
Which is like one of the challenges when it comes to like doing a motion graphic, because, you know, it's like, you know, sometimes less is more too.
Especially minimalism.
Yeah, minimalism. But, you know, the challenge with minimalism is getting at what you're trying to say also.
I look at it like Japanese cooking, you know, like Japanese cooking is like delicious. There's not too much into it. There's like some key ingredients that need to be there, but overall it's a simple but delicious meal.
Yeah, it's just highlighting the ingredient to its fullest.
Yeah, that makes me think of like sushi and like, wow, that's a crazy concept.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, it's not a lot, but it tastes great, right? I don't know what it's it
like,
is. Why?
It's like you mending like the, you know, 'cause you know, like when you have like your protein, then you have your what's rice,
like carb.
Your carb and sometimes then you have like your veggies and stuff like that,
right?
You and usually like you would just like scoop it into your mouth or something like that. But the Japanese, they straight up mended it all together and like and it just made it like bite size for y'all. I mean, and that's the beauty of design too, because it's like, you know, there's multiple ways to do something. You know,
it's gotta be digestible.
Digestible. I mean, and you know, like granted, like there's more than one right way too, you know. You know, that's what's beautiful about design too. It's like how can you like, you know, create something or innovate something into something new. Maybe not something totally original, but like, you know, has your thought and your, or collectively our thought into it,
and flavor. So
you know, so that's pretty much like sauce,
you know?
Sauce, you know. So I mean, I just wanted to make that candy, you know, so.
It's like a white rabbit candy right now.
I love that color palette.
Yes.
But you know, I'm sure we all, so I don't want to like go too technical on the stuff, so because we're kind of short on time too. But yeah, I mean, that's what I you know, I was definitely like got a lot of good feedback on it. You know, so
yeah,
I mean, I was just lurking, other people's posts and being like, well, what'd they say about it? But I mean it was this is like, yeah, something we have to collectively came up with too. I mean, the technicalities of the, you know, the behind the scenes on the After Effects, really not that difficult, but it's really the concept of like what's gonna move and stuff like that. And the feeling of it, in you know, with the you know, with a dash of branding.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that you brought in the 4-7-8 breathing technique, because I had never even heard of that before.
Same.
Yeah,
like the name itself, like 4-7-8 thing, I was like, oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah,
I mean, I didn't know that either.
Too.
I didn't know that either. I mean, there's definitely a lot of different exercises that you could do, and so I was researching some stuff like, oh, like, because you know, we need a method for motion. You kind of need some like almost like a count, you know, like what's the timing to everything, you know, or you know, I don't want to just make it up. Mm-hmm. When somebody like start making people hyperventilate.
Yeah. Pass out.
Yo, you know, I was kind of doing this all wrong, because when you start inhaling for 4 seconds, when you get to the hold part, I was still like inhaling. Like, I was like, why am I losing my breath? I was like, oh shit, I have supposed to hold, like,
and some, yeah, and sometimes it helps expand
your chest.
I don't even know. That's, yeah, you're just like, yeah, your, like, lung capacity.
Yeah.
And then like exhaling for 8 seconds, that's a long time to exhale too. Yeah. I didn't realize. But like, yeah, it really, well, you gotta calm you down.
The thing is, you don't like just let it all out, like all your air, you let it seep out through the duration of the 8 seconds. So that's what's training you. So that's, I mean, it's just, it's like just how, because that's what I was doing too. I was just like inhaling, and then when it was exhale, I would just let all my air out. But it's more about like just seeping it out for that duration. So it's calming you also. It's like slowing you down. And I mean, when your lungs are, it's like an, it's a muscle too.
Definitely.
And sometimes you don't pay attention to that, where it's like, especially something as simple as like breathing, you know, that's like, I mean, a lot of Asian martial arts, you know, they train in this type of stuff, because it's like, you know, a lot of it was for warfare, so you got to be like, you can't just be like tripping,
right?
Yeah, you can't lose your breath. You have to be able to have momentum and stamina,
just flow, and just flow, because you might be breathing hard too, don't get me wrong, but it's just like, it's just like controlling that that part of you, because it's like,
yeah, you don't want to be hyperventilating.
But yeah, I mean, I'm excited for more shit we could do that has like, you know, intent, like especially motion graphics, and there's a lot to you know, we're in, you know, the truth is we're like in a mobile world, you know, with digital everything, especially like Zoom and YouTube, Instagram, whatever,
right?
But yeah, I'm excited for the next shit that we can do, and thanks for people.
And just like scrub through a little bit, like
I'll just play it once. Like, you mean a scrub through or play it?
Or just kind of like talk about the shapes and like how, like the I don't know.
I mean, yeah, for more technical. I mean, we had some other you know, versions of this too. I felt like the way that everything spaced is kind of like a poster too. Like more.
Yeah, I feel like the whole like circle. It feels like, you know, when you're like your lung expanding, right?
Right.
And contracting and.
Yeah, I think a lot of the shapes you use were on par with the whole experience, like a circle, you know, like growing.
And like even like that whole loading, like the circle kind of going around. Yeah, like it's very. I love circles.
Well, yeah, and it's also very like ties back into the campaign too, because I mean, like one of the biggest images that you see is a circle, right? And so I'm glad that that kind of developed into that. Where cause, I mean, I didn't want to do something that was like kind of separate from this whole thing too,
right?
So we have like, you know, we have like circles, and we have the color palette's very, because I mean the color palette, I want to talk about the color palette, is very intentional too,
correct?
Like I'm sure we had fights over that too.
We had like a whole envision thing about it, you know.
Yeah, I mean, like we had first a couple visions that were very like, you know, pretty similar. But I mean, it wasn't like the thing about working in a motion graphic with a team, it's like there's a lot. I think there's you got to do the pre-production first.
Yep.
Like you got to talk about it. You got to get everybody on the same page, because it's just like, it's like imagine building a house like after without anybody's.
That's a good analogy.
like without anybody's input on like the people that want to build product. It or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then they're just like, oh shit, this is not what we wanted, you know, yeah. or something like that. You know, so I mean, there's a lot of discussion and a lot of, you know, like mood boards and, mm-hmm. and just even like type too. Type, you would think type is so simple, but with our team, it's just very like dead ass serious type shit.
Mm. Oh, it's serious.
We care about our colors. We send exact hex codes to each other.
But yeah, I mean, that's like, you know, design and stuff, but. I mean, even like the everybody's very everybody's already like super attentive to that shit already. Mm-hmm. So imagine that times four, mm-hmm. and Belinda's case times four already.
Yeah, that's times eight.
You know, it's just like that multiplier. The multiplier is there and shit. And it's just, I mean, that's at the same time, that's the beauty of a team too, because you know, like you got to have people that really want to like. Bring it to the next level and not settle for, you know, for less, you know.
Mm. I don't want us to be mediocre.
Mm-hmm. And sometimes, like, you know, yeah, it's just like, it's frustrating. Yeah, like I mean, that's just the whole dynamic working with a team and shit. Mm. Imagine playing with Michael Jordan and shit, and he's just like grilling you every game and shit, but because of that, you guys weren't able to get the championship. Mm. So
you know, sacrifices, man.
I mean, it is. It's like it has to hurt some way, you know, like in any kind of way, because if it's like too easy, then it's just like anybody can do it, really.
Mm. Dude, you know what I didn't realize? That Steve Kerr was part of the Bulls. Like,
oh, yeah. Hell yeah.
I didn't know that. That was, yeah, I did not know that.
I think
all.
He was like a very
I don't watch basketball like that, you know.
Mm. Oh yeah, I mean, it's a bit, the game of basketball is pretty interesting. Even Phil Jackson was super like zen-like.
No, I didn't realize that either. Like that dude, yeah. Apparently used to be a hippie and like takes acid, and then like also was able to lead these guys. Like he was part of the Bulls, and then he like took over the Lakers. I was like, whoa, I didn't realize.
He's one of the best coaches of all time.
Legendary, bro.
And he's because he's conceptual. You know, he's like he thinks like a designer too. Like, you know, like that's what's crazy about like sports too, is when you can apply a theory and then. And then it works and shit. Oh fuck! You know, like
shit, I didn't realize that like Jordan whooped like Kerr in the shape. You know, like
yeah, exactly.
Practice and
then look where Steve Kerr went.
Dude, like now he's, you know,
a championship coach too.
Exactly, dude.
And that's important about being on a team, because it's like you're not gonna get exposure just from working with yourself all the time. You know, everyone has like a dope process and what they do is good.
You have to be able to train other people to reach their highest potential. Yeah.
Mm. Being coachable.
Being coachable.
Yeah, be coachable and teach at the same time, you know?
Yes.
Like don't just, you know, just keep what you have to yourself.
Like Kobe sought out, you know, help from Jordan.
Like, I mean, that's like the template.
Seeing him like at 2 a.m. about like certain techniques and shit. Like, that's crazy.
Mm. You know what's crazy? Mm. I mean, like Michael Jordan was like already that guy. He was like very like in his game. But imagine someone like Kobe coming to you and just like kind of bothering you. So that means Kobe was even more like driven than I don't want to say more, but he was just as driven to like Jordan, because he was like, you know, you have someone like that's kind of like, they're kind of like buggy, you know, they're always wanting to get knowledge and shit. Mm. Mm. And it's like, that's what it takes sometimes, you know?
Mm. Dude, you know, when Jordan came back from baseball, like sorry.
Okay. Let's get back on track.
To the video part.
We're really running out.
We're talking about MJ, but yeah, that's all I want. You know, with the motion graphic, thanks for the opportunity, and we'll just keep it moving too.
All right. Thank you, Kaz.
Yeah.
Okay, I guess it's my turn now.
Let's try to do like 7 minutes each.
7 minutes each?
That's how I was trying to go fast.
Give Don some time to.
Oh, me?
Yeah, you.
Oh.
Could it be then who?
This was where is it? I don't know where to put our window thing. I'm just gonna say that for now. These are like just some raw. I took these on my iPhone. Basically just kind of like, I didn't use everything, but I usually make like 1 second clips and kind of like, you know, figure out where to put it in here. This is a pretty simple timeline for me. It's literally just 1 second clips. Let me see if I can don't know if you can hear this shit. Are you playing music right now?
I could. Lucci's mix just ended. I was about to put on Blue in Exile.
But oh, okay.
I could pause Let it me for
just,
now.
Yeah, just pause it for now.
Okay.
What am I doing? I show you or multi.
I can't hear anything.
You can't hear anything?
No.
Hold up. I'll do I show you. Maybe that's one. It should be fine. You hear that?
Mm-mm. Do you guys hear it?
You have to do Zoom.
Oh wait, hold up.
It's okay, you don't have to play the full clip because like that one is on our launch.
Alright, fuck it. I'll just scrub through it. So
yeah.
This is the guys picked me up and then we just went to the office and did some boxing. Oh my god, it's hella laggy. Yeah, I shot these on my iPhone on a little Zhiyun cell phone gimbal. I guess you could put the Blue in XL up now.
Okay.
But yeah, I just kind of shot some B-roll. I was a fucking dumbass. I had my Sony on me and I did not. I formatted my card. And I think I deleted a folder. I was like moving some files around on my external and I just fucked up, man. I lost all my Sony footage. I had all my photos, but my footage is just gone. But yeah. And then this one is a little bit more complicated. I added in some. This is like between like my GoPro.
So shout out Wildflower, by the way.
Shout out Wildflower.
Studio Wildflower.
Ooh.
That's a cool name for a studio.
That would be hella cool.
Wildflower Studios.
Yeah, I just shot some stuff. Some B-roll of Dan shooting the product shots. Very attentive. Kind of did like a back, like I kind of put a black and white filter over some of the GoPro stuff to change it up a little bit and make the color stuff stand out. Let me get back to the Sony stuff.
Just pandemic era creating.
Yeah, with the gloves. Look at the gloves.
With the mask, with the gloves.
Where's the
at home.
At home.
The gloves at home. Man.
Kimchi gloves, man.
You can get a lot of shit done though.
Yeah.
Yeah, got some, you know, detailed shots. Look at that eye. And then,
look at the intensity of this.
Yeah. It's like
a deep void of sadness.
Yeah, I kind of, I approach my video like channel with a certain, you know, flow. I you know, speed it up a little bit, slow it down, go back to regular, kind of just to keep the audience attention.
Because,
you know, my attention will be averting sometimes too. I get a little bored, you know, so I kind of just switch it up here and there.
Mm-hmm.
And
Nice.
Nüfly.com.
Nüfly.com.
With the pronunciation marks on top of the U.
Yeah.
Yes, because we're new. Anyways, all that's right. Me.
Thank you, B. All right, Donnie.
Show your moves.
So just to tie it all together, we
I should have given you more time, bro.
It's all good. Just to briefly go over our poster, I think Dan showed us the intention page on our sheet, on our Google Sheets, kind of showing what quotes we have. And we kind of landed on "You are not alone." I think it's definitely a great quote because, especially during this pandemic, we're all struggling together as a community, as humans, and We thought this quote is something that's affirming that, you know, you're not by yourself in this. Everybody's kind of.
It can be totally creepy though if it's on the wrong poster.
Yeah,
at like, home, but you're like, you are not alone. What? Who's in my house shoulder? Right now? Yeah. Who's in my house?
I remember that.
Where's my bat at?
I remember that being Don's concern. He was like, it might sound a little creepy, but I'm glad we stuck with it. Because, you know, without context, it might sound a little out of context, or out of pocket. But I think with how we're talking about, you know, us being like really worried about things, you tend to isolate yourselves, you know, and you kind of lost in your head. You have to remind yourself, you know, to really reach out to people and talk to people. So, you know, this serves as that reminder.
So we were fascinated by like sunflowers as well, or just flowers in general, and like just looking at like a crop of flowers, it's kind of like they're all kind of growing together. So mm-hmm. we like that whole analogy, mm-hmm. very symbolic. So we kind of went towards this direction. Mm-hmm. We knew that like the circle was very calming because it's kind of like our lives, right? Like we have circles everywhere. Mm-hmm. Circle of friends, circle of family, whatever, mm-hmm. and kind of just like correlating those two, showing wholeness, showing that, you know, we're all together in this thing. Mm-hmm. We wanted to take that element, juxtapose it with flowers, you know, because mm-hmm. we're all growing together. But that kind of, this was like the early stages of our design. We just wanted to like communicate that you're not alone and like whatever, exactly. So mm-hmm. then, we're also like in the discovery phase of this whole poster thing too. Like this is something that we started on, not the zine. We started on the poster first and then went to the zine, but we're playing around with typeface. We're playing around with like different ways we could showcase the sunflower, etc. And we really like the halftone effect as well, so mm-hmm. we're kind of going
towards y'all went crazy with it.
Yeah, we had like the sunflower
tap
one
tones.
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
so you are not, so this is not it.
Concept.
That's what we concept.
This is not it.
It's not it. So we kind of moved, took elements from this whole pretty much mood board and then mm-hmm. moved over to something like this. Oh shit.
Whoa. Show it all, man. No, just show.
Show it all. Okay.
Whatever's easier for you.
He's like, all my secrets are being revealed right now. Fuck.
So going back to what we said, like, should we put "you're not alone" with the, you know, mm-hmm. apostrophe, whatever? Should we spell it all out? Mm-hmm. We like the circle. We wanted to be on brand as well, like using our color palette as a team or the branding for Nüfly, and we wanted to just kind of go back to our brand attributes, like something dreamy, something mm-hmm. that's, you know, pleasing to the eye, aesthetically pleasing. And then we also kept the sunflowers, like, you know, so.
Well, what's that version? What's that moving over?
Which one?
What's that one? The green smiley,
like that
faces.
One.
Yeah, why don't we use that?
We're repurposing it for the night drive.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. I love the
what's night drive?
Well, who knows?
Exclusive. Whoa. We're not working on anything over here.
I was very juiced on like the gradient effect. I don't know.
It hella worked out.
Kind of gradient everything. So this is a lot of versions that we went through.
Yeah.
And kind of landed on something around here. Like, I think this one was something that we landed on, and we're like, B was like, the gradient doesn't work, it's overlapping, da da da.
I'm not into that one at all.
We had changing all these little icons.
You left the Zoom call, and Dan and I were in there for like until 4 a.m.
That was a long
night. Yeah, growing pains.
That was a really long night.
Yeah, so all in all, we wanted to communicate wholeness. We wanted something that's, you know, ever-changing, gradients kind of ever-changing. Mm-hmm. Especially the quote, "you're not alone." Like, I think for me, at least, the circle represents like the moon or the sun. Mm. So, and those are the things that are, you know, always true because we see that every day, right? So that's kind of like, you're not alone. The sun or the moon is always going to be with you, kind of vibe. So that way.
That's deep.
So, yeah.
I love it.
So moving on, this is, I think, finalized version. We had like the halftone effects applied. We wanted to show this gradient still, but if you really look at the details, there's a lot of grain. Dan loves grain for some reason.
Texture.
He loves grain.
Seasoning.
He's a grain boy.
We just wanted to communicate dream and reality.
Yeah,
and
high quality grain.
Yeah.
The lines kind of communicate reality. It's something, you know, linear, something mm-hmm. that's, you know, what is it?
I mean, it's a really surreal kind of thing that you wouldn't normally see associated with a circle, I think.
Right.
And the idea that Don really like emphasized was like, make it, you know, have it play with the dream and reality. Mm-hmm. So the color palette, we made it very dreamy. The whole aesthetic is very dreamy, abstract, surreal. If you look at the background behind the circle, we actually put it's a photo of clouds. So there's that realism that we put there to try to tie everything together. We're out of time, but we still haven't got through the zine. We still haven't got through like the website creation. I know, it's fine. I'm just letting people know what we didn't talk about yet, go over yet. The launch spreads. There's just a lot of work that went in, but yeah, we're entering our third hour. We reached out to some of our friends, our contributors specifically, to come on for our live stream and to be able to share their thoughts and reflect on everything. If you guys are ready, we have Natalie and Miles in the waiting room.
About to be a party.
Okay.
Let's celebrate together.
Okay.
Let's have a party.
Miles should play a little quick set.
You going to finesse Miles into the
Okay, I'm gonna let him in right now.
Okay. Oh, he's in the car right now.
Yo, are we international, babe? No, I'm
international, bye, babe. Hi guys.
What up?
Hi,
y'all?
Natalie. What's up, Miles?
Hey, Natalie. Miles is in the car.
Natalie, I don't think we could hear you yet. And here come bringing in Lucci, and Arumi's gonna be joining us too.
Yeah. Okay, dope. Hey. She's like, 1 second.
Hi guys.
Miles, the sun behind him.
Sorry. Miles is looking like Jesus right now.
Miles, where are you?
Like, I'm not ready to go there yet, Lord, please.
Hey, what's up, Luigi?
What's up, Ruby?
What's up, Jody?
Hi, Jody. Good afternoon, guys. Where thank you so Miles much for joining at? Us.
Oh, shit.
We're just gonna wait for Miles to come through.
Oh fuck, I forgot to text Isaiah the
way to go.
I know. You got one job, Belinda.
Hold up.
Wow. Thank you guys. In the meantime, thank you guys for joining us for our last hour.
How's your guys' Saturdays?
Good. I've been asleep.
Well rested.
Yeah. Well, not well rested, but like
trying to,
you know, I'm going to go back to it after this.
Facts. Facts. I think that's what I'm doing after.
Like, now,
Natalie's here. Natalie, how are you doing today?
Okay, Isaiah's coming. Miles, where are you?
Or Miles. Let's go.
Hello.
Let's go.
Can you hear us?
Let's go say hi to everyone.
All right. Sorry.
We since you mentioned Miles.
Hold up.
Miles, how are you doing, bro?
Can you hear us?
He's like staring into our souls. Maybe while Miles, I think his internet's just catching up. Natalie, how are you? Thank you for joining us today.
Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
We can hear you now.
Hear you.
Sorry, I'm like over here just figure my shit out. I'm good. Yeah, I'm good. Busy, but happy to be here.
Thank you. Hey. Hey.
You're a little bit quiet. Yo.
Yo.
What's up? Oh, yeah. Hello, yes. Miles. What's up, Miles? What's up? Are you on the way to somewhere? Grocery shopping? Plant shopping?
I'm on the way home.
Oh, nice.
Plant shopping? You pick up some plants? Some sheep?
Hey.
I'm on the way home.
Nice. You drive a truck?
A bike ride.
Huh? Oh, nice.
You drive a truck?
My boy. This is my boy's truck.
Oh, for sure. Back. So, okay. Yeah.
Nice. Miles, thank you for being here, man.
Isaiah's
here too.
We got Isaiah. What up?
Let him connect to audio. Okay, there we go. What up, bro?
What's up, Isaiah?
Hey. Oh my god, the gang's
nice
all here.
Nice to see you guys.
Woo! Shit, I gotta take a picture right now. Hold up a second.
I just want to play Waka Flocka. It's a party.
All right. Hey. Get some swag surf going on.
And Jody, nice. Last but not least, Jody.
Yay.
What's up, Jody?
Hello.
Where are you right now?
It's at my apartment in Lafayette.
Oh, what?
Are you in your closet?
No, not today. Not in the closet.
Dude, her closet is a whole fucking room, bro. Like,
dang.
What? Like,
got like a little day's bed sofa in there.
Dang. Yeah.
Made it our like record storage area. So.
Wow.
And, nice.
Damn. Awesome. Well, everyone, thank you so much for joining us right now. We wanted to dedicate an hour for our live stream just to have everyone all on the same page. We wanted to give everyone like an opportunity if you wanted to maybe talk about your involvement with Care Package 1. We wanted to give you guys an update also that we sold out already more than half of our inventory. I think
we're
at 37 orders already. So big round of applause for everyone. So yeah, the four of us, we basically just wanted to host you guys. We have specific questions for you each, but maybe we could, you know, start with Natalie. Natalie, if you want to maybe share a little bit about your stories about creating candles for us, we love it. We're excited to package it together. If you want to share anything with everyone, like your experience, how is it like?
Yeah, can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Certainly. Okay, good. yeah, so this was a super fun project to work on. I've been doing ceramics for more than 10 years now, but I kind of took a hiatus after I graduated college and then got back into it about a year ago. Mm-hmm. So yeah, this project was cool. My studio had closed when the shelter in place order first went into effect, so I ended up setting up kind of like a home studio situation and was able to do this project at home. And then my studio, Merit Ceramics, helped with the firing process. I do have some like images and footage from the process that I could try sharing if you guys want to see it.
That'd be great.
Let me try to share my screen. I think this will work. Alright, can I see this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Nice.
Cool. So ceramics is a really lengthy process. Clay has to be fired twice, but I chose the most simplest hand building technique to make these candles.
Can you full screen that without the presenter notes?
Oh shoot! Sorry. Yeah.
We CC your screen.
It's because I have my monitor plugged in.
Okay, there we go.
Gotcha.
Nice.
All right. Cool. So yeah, I made these forms with the pinch pot technique, which is like a super simple hand building technique. You probably would learn it. It's like the first thing you learn in ceramics. So you start out with the maps of me working on the forms. Mm-hmm. It's simple, but it takes a while to like shape the form because you have to go slowly and let the clay gradually dry while you build out the shape. Mm-hmm. So I had to kind of go over them multiple times. And as you can see, it starts as like just little tiny pinch pots. Then I slowly build them out and out until I have like a form that has even walls and is light enough and big enough to hold what we're trying to put in it, which is wax.
Wow.
So this is kind of the second step. So after I built the form, I play around with texture a lot in my ceramics, and for this particular design, I wanted to do a really kind of like matte finish with a glossy glaze inlay. I do that pretty commonly with my pieces. So basically what I have to do is wait till the clay dries enough so that it's leather hard. And then I paint the outside with black underglaze, which is basically just like paint for clay. And then I use this tool right here. I don't know if you can see my mouse, but yeah, this little green and brown tool to carve patterns into the leather hard clay. And the picture on the right is kind of the end result. So that's kind of the last stage of working with the raw clay. And then it goes to the first firing, which is a bisque fire. It takes about 24 hours from the time you put it in to the time it's ready to be unloaded. And this picture on the left is what they looked like when they came out. This picture was taken at my studio. And then these are some photos of the glazing process. I glazed the inside with the glossy white, and then used a little tool to pipe the glaze into the cracks, and then I had to wipe the surface glaze away. So this is what it looks like before I wipe the glaze, and then after I wipe the glaze here. Wow. And then this picture on the bottom right is what they look like after the glaze firing, which also takes about 24 hours to do.
Wow. It's a lot of work.
Yeah.
A lot of hours.
Yeah, yeah. Clay is a very labor-intensive art form, but if you enjoy the process, it's really worth it to see kind of the transformation. I think that's why I love it so much, is because it's kind of like an emotional roller coaster when you're working on a piece. It's like sometimes you'll be frustrated, sometimes you'll hate how it looks, but then sometimes, you know, it'll come out of the kiln and you'll be excited with the end result. And so, yeah. And then I just started in the last year, I think around the holiday season, I just started experimenting with candles. So this was cool to be able to kind of revisit that with making soy wax candles. I didn't take any pictures or footage of the actual like melting of the wax, but it's really simple to do at home. All you need is soy wax and like a pot or pitcher to melt it in on your stove. And then I use essential oils to scent my soy wax, but you can also buy synthetic fragrances if you want something that's not available as an essential oil. But for this project, I used lavender and lemongrass, and just you melt the wax on the stove, and then you have to let it cool and a little bit, and then you add the essential oils, and then it's ready to pour. And this is a time lapse of me pouring. I'm like in my pajamas in my apartment. But yeah, this is what it looks like to pour. I think I did like 8 or 10 at a time. But yeah, you pour, you put the wicks in. I use like pencils to keep the wicks upright.
pencils.
And then you let it dry.
Okay.
Yeah, you can buy like little, I mean, you can really use anything just to make sure that the wick's not leaning to keep it centered while the wax dries. So
that's cool.
Yeah. And this is like, I don't know, it's me pouring it. But yeah, and then the picture on the right is kind of what they look like at the end, and you just turn the wick and they're ready to go.
It came out amazing.
So this is my project.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank
dude.
You. Yeah. Thanks.
It seems very meditative too to work on it, right? You kind of get into a zen space.
Yeah, definitely. Where'd you guys go? Yeah, it was fun, and it definitely helped me get back into my practice as an artist, because I think when everything started with COVID, it was hard to find inspiration to create, and this was kind of my first opportunity to get back into it. And then I started doing more coil building at home, and then my studio opened a few weeks ago, so I've been back in there, and I'm excited about all the new things I'm creating.
Nice. Hey,
beautiful.
You know what, that's part of our purpose too at Nüfly, help artists, you know, realize lost motivations. So really happy that, you know, you were able to get back on that.
Yeah. Nah, I think the candles were that was like the first idea for what the contents were going to be for the care package, and I'm really glad Belinda brought you into this because you nailed this project. We're really excited. We're after the stream actually, like, we're going to be packaging them finally together with everything and start fulfilling these orders. So great job, Natalie, like, you nailed it. We're really excited for people to physically hold it and be able to experience it also. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Before we go into specific questions, I do want to just make sure that we have all of our contributors be able to say what they want also. So how about we continue going in the round table. Belinda arranged an order of what we felt would be a great way for people to listen to these mixes in sequence. So with that order in mind, we're gonna tend to each of our DJs who created really dope mixes for us. The first one from our playlist was Isaiah. So Isaiah, thank you for joining us today. We wanted to know if you could share with us some stories on the creation process, the whole experience, what your intentions were with this, what do you maybe hope that someone will take away listening to your mix?
First of all, thanks for having me, guys. I'm definitely the wild card, like Belinda said in the beginning. Definitely like who's that? But this process was actually, it was super therapeutic for me as well. Belinda actually hit me up, what was it, March, early April?
Yeah.
And I was in the parking lot of my job. I work in an ED as a nurse. So I was actually stressing out in my car, and I get this DM from Belinda. She's like, hey.
Oh, you were stressing out, shit.
I was stressing out in my
damn
car. I have like pre-shift anxiety. And she's
I bet, dude. Fuck, it's Corona right now too, and you're in the fucking hospital being a nurse in the ER, right? Dude. Like, that's crazy.
It's intense, but you know, you have to find your own way to cope. And music is definitely my way of, you know, calming myself down. And that's essentially how I guided myself with my mix. So when I drive to work, I need to listen to something that helps me calm down. And I was like, she told me the theme about like anxiety and what, you know, what puts you like in the right state of mind, what refreshes you. And I was like, well, this is perfect because I literally do it every time I go into work. And I guess
you haven't put out a mix in a while too, so I was like, yeah. Yo, where's the next mix at? I need that.
Right, it's been a long time. I overthink a lot of things, and I try a lot of things, but I always like stop myself short, essentially. But
I can tell you're a perfectionist, man. That's why I tapped you too.
I think to a fault, but
we can
I guess a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. You know, like, for sure.
Growing up, I grew up in church, and I grew up in like a gospel church, so that was the kind of music I listened to, and I realized it was like a lot of brass and bass lines in gospel music. And eventually, you know, as I started to listen to more and more music, that progressed into the kind of hip hop I liked, and the kind of not just hip hop, but like music in general that I liked. And that kind of guided my selections for the mix. And I actually sent Belinda a mix. Early on, and it was totally like the wrong idea. Belinda was like, "Yeah, this is nice, but like that's totally not what we're going for." And I was like, "Actually, yeah, like you're right. You're
right."
You
sent me a 1-4-3 wedding mix, bro. Yo, this is not a wedding right now.
Right, I was like, all right, let
you
me,
start
let me
off
reset.
With you don't have to call by Usher. And I was like, yeah. Not for this one. Sorry.
Yeah, it was totally left field, but one day I sat down and I closed my eyes and I was like, all right, like what helps me relax, you know? And I kind of went on this journey. Not a journey, but like this trip, like you kind of put things on shuffle and you close your eyes and you kind of like think like, all right, what puts me in the right state of mind? What helps me like remember like you're okay, calm down. And that's what essentially guided my mix. Like I started out with, forgive me guys, I just came from work.
You're good.
So I'm a little scatterbrained.
Sorry.
But, no, it's all good.
There's a lot of sax in the mix.
A lot of sax.
A lot of sax.
And a lot of instrumentals. The instrumentals kind of like, for me, they kind of created scenes. And it was all about like flow, right? So it's like an up and down. It's kind of like a happy mix, but also it's like there's a lot of like beats in between that kind of make you think, at least for me. You know, make you reflect and make you
that last Kanye track was like so gospel-y. Like I was definitely like in church.
Yeah, super gospel. That's one, like,
yeah,
that's definitely like an influence of like, you know, where I came from at least, and the type of music that I grew up listening to. But it was a therapeutic experience for me. It's something that helped me relax, you know, and I hope it does has the same effect for other people.
It's beautiful.
Definitely, yeah. Dude. Damn. Definitely. I had to start off with that, the sax edits and everything. It just kind of set the tone, you know?
Right, yeah. Right. Exactly. Sorry, I was a little bit scatterbrained. I was trying to.
It's okay. You're good, man. It's all good. You still nailed it. Yeah.
Nice.
Okay. Dope.
But
Miles.
Thank
dude.
You guys for having
Sorry.
Me.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, dude, Isaiah, I need another mix. I need to listen to the mix that you sent me to, but bring on in. We gotta get another one from you. I can't talk right now. I'm fucking tired too. I fell asleep with the lights on last night. Okay, guys, I'm sorry. Like, getting my shit together right now. Yeah. Thank you, Isaiah.
Thank you, guys.
Cool. All right, Miles. What's up, dude? How you doing?
What's up, guys? How are you guys?
We're good. We're good.
Thanks for joining.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Miles, if you could tell us, well, first and foremost, Belinda praised your mix a lot when she received it. She was sharing it very enthusiastically with the team. And like, it was hella dope. You did your thing. It sounded like a Miles mix. Like, it was very technical. If you could share with us some of your thoughts, your experience, maybe what you hope the listener would take away listening to your mix.
I remember like when she asked me to do it, it was like, it was already like, how far into COVID was it? Like a month or so?
Yeah, I think so, over a month. Yeah.
Yeah. So, since it was already a month into COVID, I had no influences of the club or being out or anything like that. So I thought it was like a cool opportunity to just like play whatever I was kind of into. And I remember I don't make mixes, so like, I remember like that was like the only mix I ever made. Like unless it was guest mixes, but usually guest mixes is like for a radio show or somebody's show, so there's kind of somewhat of a format. You know what I mean? Like usually it's not like just do your thing type of mix. So I definitely took advantage of just being, I remember I just wanted to be really honest on this one. And I remember like she hit me when it was like it had got buried in some shit, so like she hit me and she was like, can you still send this to me tomorrow? And I was like, oh fuck. So like I literally like I was doing another project that I had finished like really late, like 2 a.m. or something. And I was super tired, but I was like, I don't feel like doing this tomorrow and sending it to her. So I was like, let me just kind of like stay up and
so that was a 2 a.m. mix.
It was like really late.
The next morning and I noticed you sent it to me at 5 a.m. I was like, what the fuck, dude?
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Honestly, it'd be like that sometimes. Yo, I think you were like the first one to turn your mix too out of everybody. Jody was like the one that told me, is like, because I initially asked her first. I was like, yo, can I get a mix from you? She was like, yeah, you can get 20 minutes. I was like, okay, fine. So I told everybody else, like, yo, I need a 20-minute mix. And then this girl sends me a 33-minute mix at the end. She's like, the last one is time, like, learn. Turn, I was like, what the fuck, dude? I was like, well, I want this, so I'm not going to tell you to cut it down. And also, she had to re-record it, too. She had recorded it once and was like, she sent it to me. I was like, oh, this is dope. She's like, no. No, I need to fix it. I'm re-recording it right now. I was like, what the fuck? It's like, I sent it to the guys already. He's like, why did you do that? I was like, I thought you were done, but apparently not. Shit.
Dang.
You gotta get it right.
That was like such...
Huh? What?
That was like the big appeal of it too, was like, oh, it's 20 minutes. I'm like, okay, I could do a 20-minute mix for sure. Mm. Then, I mean, of course, I would have said yes regardless, but... 20 was a nice little, like, okay.
All right, just all right, enough. Jody. All right. Good idea.
Nice. Yeah. Miles,
thanks
thank
for the
you.
Mix, man.
We
seriously.
Love it, man.
Yeah. Glad to have
you. Oh, yeah. I'm glad you guys are in good, though. But yeah, just since I never make mixes, like, I was actually, and that was like a very honest one. Mm-hmm. I like it. Like, you know, I usually don't like anything. So that I do like it. So that's one that
I hated his do-over set last year when, like, the crowd's feeling it. He was like, nah, I bombed. And then he had a terrible mushroom trip afterwards. I was like,
we're really,
what am I going to do with you?
We're really sometimes our worst critic, but it's always a treasure when you actually create something that you actually, like, personally really enjoy. So It sounds like, Miles found something like that, so thank you, Miles. We hella enjoyed it too, man. It's really dope.
Cool, man. Thanks, man.
Yeah, yeah.
That's exclusive. Hey.
All right, we're just talking about Jody. Let's hear it from Jody. Jody, tell us about your experience with the mix, what your intentions were, and maybe what you hope the listener will take away while listening to your mix.
So, first of all, congrats, y'all, on the drop.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, with the time issue, I mean, 20 minutes seemed like really doable at that time. And, you know, I still stand behind 20 minutes, but sometimes you get started and then you just, like, kind of want to keep going a little bit. So.
Get in the groove.
Yeah, but I just, like, wanted to create a mix that was chill, because I'm, like, a super chill person, and with everything going on right now, it's a little crazy, so something to listen that's easy on the ears. I wanted to be, like, feel good, but, like, a little familiar, so I threw in some remixes, and, yeah, I just hope whoever's listening to it enjoys it and can vibe out.
Mm-hmm.
That's your mix is Dan's favorite mix.
It is.
There's Dan, so nice. Thank you.
I love all four. I can't say any favorites right now because I picked everybody. But yeah, you're Dan's favorite.
Just for context, everyone's mix was super fire. I'm just personally a very funk, like, geared towards person. And then when I heard some of those tracks, I was like, all right, yeah, Jody.
Yeah, we have a super similar music taste.
Yeah.
Too.
Yeah. So. Big props on that.
Maximum chill.
Maximum chill.
I was asking everybody for descriptions of their mix, and she sent me maximum chill. I was like, all right, fuck it. Putting that in there.
Nice. Was this easy to put together, Jody?
Yeah, like, once, like, I got in the groove, I was able to, like, put all the songs together, and it was a good mix. For me, just nice. Like in terms of how it all came together.
It was the selection was really fun, like, going through, and I just felt like it was something really easy that I would have heard if we attended one of your sets, you know, that it's like something that you could listen to and dance to at home, but it'd be suitable with big speakers as well. I remember,
I feel like your mix is the kind of mix I'll go running on, like, all right, I'm ready to get energized. Let's go.
I remember I was telling the team that we wanted to give you guys a lot of freedom with the mix, because we understand when it comes down to like dealing with anxiety, everyone listens, everyone has like their own preference, you know, everyone has their own taste. There's a large range in what our community listens to, and I think it's really nice that, you know, you guys kind of did your own thing. So when everything is kind of come together, like the user just, it's just a delightful experience for the user to kind of have that broad spectrum. Nice. Thank you, Jody.
Thanks, Jody.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate I want you. Another mix from everybody. So
it's
Lindsay,
super hard to say no to
with us, by the way. I can tell you're like just so in the corner.
It's been a rough couple of weeks, guys.
I feel it.
How's your dad doing right now?
I think he's golfing right now. He's like,
oh, he's golfing. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so he's good. Right. He's good.
He seems like he's fine now. All right.
Oh, nice. He's asymptomatic. My brother is the only one who got it from him.
Oh,
and,
what?
Yeah. That's what happens when you hug my father. I don't hug him.
Oh, shit. Okay. 6 feet away with the stick.
So my brother he lost a sense of smell, and that's it. But he's fine now. Like, they're fine. I think it just takes hard. Like, it's harder for you guys to bounce back. That's what I keep hearing from everybody. Like, they're just like, oh, like my dad just the other day was like, oh, I'm starting to feel like 100%. Like, but other than that, I mean, they're still annoying. They're fine.
They're still annoying. Fuck those guys.
They'll be all right.
Okay. I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah, they're fine. But yes,
thanks for coming through and doing this.
Of course. Always.
Happy for your mix. You know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Tell us about it.
Belinda hit me up. Well, I think she saw one of my posts. I was like, I think everybody's struggling during this time. It's just weird, shitty time. And so she was just like, you need to create. So here's this project I'm putting together. And I procrastinated because that's what I do.
She was the last one to turn it in. I had to send her all everybody's Dropbox links. Yeah. I was like, yo, we got everybody else's. Where's your at?
Right. And I think because for me, I'm very family oriented. Like, my family is my heart. And I hadn't seen them, even though they're 20 minutes away. And because my grandpa was staying with them at the time, I couldn't go over there and see my family. So like I've seen my dad because we worked together, but I hadn't seen my mom, and that's like my heart, and I hadn't hugged her or anything like that. So she came over because my girlfriend surprised me, and my mom came over, and we just hugged for like 5 minutes, and I was like, all right, I can do this mix now. Thanks, LaDonna. Like, I'm good to go. And that's really what this mix is like, even though the first song is Taste by Tyga, you know, it has nothing. But it just reminded me of like, because it's a remix, it's a Cook and Soul remix, and it just reminded me of like my family, like get-togethers and kickbacks and just time to just relax and have music in the background and like just chill out, you know, and just have a good time with your family, I guess. So that's really what it was based on. It was like right when I hugged my mom, I was like, all right, I got it. I can do this now, you know. So. Nothing like the comfort of your mother's arms, I guess.
For real, dude.
Yeah.
But,
yeah. So.
Nice.
Well, I think, what were you saying?
I was going to say, could we talk about your selection also?
Yeah, man.
Boom baps. Like, I think that's a huge, huge core for a lot of us, like, especially during my college days, like a huge Dilla fan, Jabez at that time. Just hearing that was really refreshing, like in your mix.
No, I love jazz. And so anytime you could like, I don't know, make a vibe out of it, as people would say. I just like stuff like that. And I like to make stuff like that and listen to it. So I thought that like, you know, I would give you guys a piece of me, I guess. And just, you know, go from there. Cause I'm really big on stuff like that. And I knew that it was like a chill. It was just a way to chill and I guess chill your anxiety. And that usually helps me. It's like smoking and putting on some boom bap and lo-fi.
Definitely. Some sage and bourbon.
Yeah, and call it a day. That's okay. Yeah, I haven't had bourbon in a while. I'm proud of myself. Shit. I know. I'm very proud of myself.
What's your drink of choice right now?
A Negroni.
Okay.
What is that?
Yeah. It is
gin,
Campari, and what's that? I just made it. gin, Campari, and something else. I don't know. Oh, sweet vermouth.
Oh,
okay. Vermouth. Wow.
Sounds refreshing.
And like it's like an old fashioned without the gin and Campari.
So, fancy.
Yeah. Nice. It's a good little Italian drink, I think. I don't know. I'm an alcoholic.
We're pulling up to Lucci's place. We're going to LA, man.
My bar drinks. Cart. I would show you guys my bar cart right now. It's
where is it?
But it's right here. Can you guys see it?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Sorry.
You're ready for quarantine.
Listen, you guys need like anything for the pandemic, we got it.
we'll stock.
Well
equipped.
Yeah, we'll stock, yeah. Like a full on liquor store.
Nice. Oh.
Nice. Yeah.
Thank you, Lucci. And for side note, your mix was Don's favorite.
Don's getting a special mix. He's getting a personal mix.
There it is. Nice.
I like everybody's mixes.
Yes, yes, just for context.
You don't have to make them feel good about themselves. Okay?
Oh my god.
Hey.
What a relief, man, to fucking finish this. Like, yeah. This took us so long. Natalie had all her candles done for us like months ago. She's been like waiting, like, okay, it's fucking July. Why was I on this like 3-week plan? Like, why did I give you guys all your
all good?
It took
I would have cried if you needed it.
I think it's because we just wanted to package it as well as we could.
Yeah, there's a lot of things to do. There's a lot of things we realized that we didn't have, you know, that like one of the biggest things was like the website. We didn't even think about during the early stages when we were launching this that like, oh, okay, you know, like we're just gonna put together a cool care package. And then it wasn't until like, I think like early June, Don was like, how are we gonna sell this? And we're like, oh shit, you know. And so it bloomed into like a lot more things that we needed to do. But we got it out. The people have been like, our community has been sharing it very, like, it's been,
yeah, shout out to Isaiah's homies, by the way. We were getting all these orders from New Jersey and the guys were like, yo, who the fuck is buying all this shit from New Jersey? And I'm like, I don't remember. And then like Isaiah texted me the next day, it's like, yo, some of my homies got up. Oh, that was you. Okay, I get it.
They were all,
we got friends. Some East Coast friends over there.
They were really excited once it dropped. You're like, what? And like, people just started buying it. I was like, it's like, that's what's up. They really do want to support, and they were excited about the project. So,
wow!
Hey, shout out to the East Coast. Say, like,
you guys are doing it. It's almost countrywide.
Oh yeah, basically coast to coast.
Coast to coast, exactly.
Yeah, I received a message from like a nurse friend, and he was like, yeah, I got some for myself and my nurse colleagues. I'm like, nice, some nurses getting this shit, like they need it, you know. Out of everybody, they probably need it the most out of all of us. I can't talk right now.
Now you're good. Thank you guys, everyone. I wanted to give us some time to maybe just have a group discussion. Some questions that we had that we would like everyone's opinions on, or just like feel free to chime in. We wanted to talk about maybe what this care package maybe meant to you, or maybe even broader, you know, like what does mental health mean to you at this time? I think this is something, especially due to COVID-19, that has been, we've been kind of forced into positions where we have a lot of time to think about ourselves. And sometimes it's a little overwhelming. Sometimes we tend to isolate one another. Personally for me, I think that's my coping mechanism. Usually when I go through things, or if I'm going through it, for example, I feel whatever reason I don't really talk about it as much as what's happening in my head. Like I feel like I'm going through scenarios, I'm talking with myself, I'm arguing with myself all in my head. But then when I'm with my friends or my families, like I'm like this kind of like shell of myself. I'm not really present, you know? So I think one thing I'm really taking away from this whole experience is I'm trying to be a lot more quick about getting what's in my head out to people around me who are asking around. if anyone wants to share some stories, maybe so either, you know, what this care package, what does it mean to you, or maybe what does mental health mean to you at during this time?
Yeah, I'll chime in. I think, you know, especially during this time, it's like, I feel like everything leading up to now, I was prepping for this moment, you know, just like COVID, just like, I'm an introvert. I like staying at home. I'm a homebody, all that. And it's not too different from like what I was doing on my normal days. but I think my biggest gripes now is just like doing dishes all the time.
That's bro.
And like just
that's
thinking,
the struggle. Thinking I have to about wash all like, my own dishes now. Yeah. Fuck.
Like thinking about my second dinner or my third
dinner. What? You're making three dinners, bro?
I don't know. We're stuck at home, you know, like you don't want to order.
You're that hungry. Are you stress eating over there?
No, but just like I think, you know, going back to the whole anxiety thing, it's like we're just trying to figure out like when we'll get out of this, right? Like when will things go back to normal? And I think coming, like, going back to it, just kind of knowing that this might be the normal now, you know? It's, like, very hard to think about, you know? And I think us putting this, all of us putting this care package together, it's, like, something that hits all the places for everybody, right? It's like music therapy, like, journaling, something that, you know, like we're the homies for a lot of people, and I love just sharing that. And yeah, I'm so happy for all of this, like you guys contributing too. That's like such a blessing, like especially B hitting all y'all up and you guys just, you know, went with it. That's such a beautiful thing, and I really appreciate you guys like coming together, to be honest.
Y'all
are
the best.
Y'all the best.
The goats.
Yeah, that's me. We want to take over.
I mean, it's pretty cool that you guys dropped this project, and I haven't met half of you, but we all can collaborate and come out with something that can maybe like ease some anxiety, and even if it just helps one person, like that's still really awesome. And just like the whole visual aid, you guys made it all pretty. It's just like nice to look at, you know, like all the graphics design. It's just nice to look at. So
we're real pretty over here. Cool. Real pretty.
I guess I'll chime in. Can you guys hear me or no?
Yeah, we hear you.
I think this mix is, or this whole package is very timely because of what's like, not only is COVID, but what's going on in the world too. And I know that mental health is such a stigma in the Black community. Like, we don't talk about it. It's like, hey, go pray that away. You'll be fine, you know? But to see like people actually talking about it and, you know, realizing that a lot of people, like, I'm blessed to be able to live with my girlfriend, but like a lot of people don't have somebody right now. And like, you may think that they're okay, because they're like, you know, you see them on social media, you talk to them, but they're really struggling right now. Like, it's a lonely, lonely time, because not only like, yeah, we all are introverted, or most of us are introverted in here and we were prepared for this, but like, there's also a difference of being like, I just want to be in the house, and like having the option to leave though. Like, I want that option, or being able to like pick and choose who I hug, or, you know, give a handshake to. Like, now I can't do that, you right. know? Like, now it's like, I'll see you later, call me, whatever. But I think that this package is has opened a lot of people and like my friends and my community's eyes, because it's something that we do need to talk about. It's not a joke. Mental health is a real ass thing, and it's not something that you could just pray away and just call it a day. That's, you know, it's a real ass thing. So I thank you guys for this, and I'm thankful that I'm able to be a part of it. So thanks.
Thank you. No, for real. Like, I'm so happy you guys were a part of this. I feel like inherently, like, all you guys are like really good people. And I'm just happy that I was able to connect everybody together.
Just adding off of what Luchi mentioned too, we I think like it's really easy to kind of like self-diagnose yourself, saying like, oh, I got anxiety, or I got OCD, you know. It was part of our intention when we were putting together the zine to have like we intentionally put like a full definition of anxiety, and we put words that are commonly associated, or feelings, with the hope that when someone kind of reads the poster zine, they have a better sense of what anxiety means, and that there's like a lot of kind of, how should I say, like umbrellas of what, you know, comes from anxiety. That I hope that when people like read it, by kind of understanding what it means, they have a better sense of what they're feeling, you know, because like the alternative case, I feel like, especially on like this Twitter age, you know, we're really quick to like, I got depression, you know, shout out to depression, you know, but to kind of have a more better understanding of what it actually means to have this kind of mental condition, or maybe understand what you're feeling, I hope it just helps someone kind of get them to the next step of like overcoming it, or kind of like addressing it, you know, rather than just kind of like, oh yeah, I got that. Yeah.
Yeah.
For me, this care package meant a lot. And the common theme for me was honesty. Mm-hmm. I feel like you guys provided a platform where each of us could be 100% genuine and honest. And, you know, I'm very grateful for that, because for a long time I was discouraged because I felt like what I chose to make and create out of my mixes was something that was honest for me, but had no appeal, you know? Not that all that I'm going for is appeal, but like, it's kind of discouraging to think like, oh, like no one else is, you know, everyone else is trying to like fit an agenda, or, you know, like essentially like fill like a top 40s mix, something mm-hmm. along those lines, right? But it was nice to, you know, to see that you guys are a community that's honest and genuine, mm-hmm. and that's something I respect about you guys. And it was encouraging to see like, oh, there's a community of people that wanna do this for the love of it, you know. Mm. And in relation to mental health, like it reminded me to be honest about it, you know, like it's okay to not be okay, it's okay to be uncomfortable, you know. And it's life, you know, it's ups and downs, but you don't always have to be okay, you just have to be honest about it, you know. So those things are like one and two, like the same, you know. Be honest with what you create, be honest with yourself. And I'm just grateful that you guys created this community. Like, I didn't know that this was the biggest picture, and now that you guys are done with it, like, it's encouraging, and it really inspires me to keep going, because it's like, all right, like, it's cool that there's a community of people that want to be genuine and honest, and like, that's where each of us are coming from, and it's like encouraging, so like, to move forward with that thought.
Damn, thank you.
So
deep, you know, man. I love it hard.
I feel like kind of dovetailing off that, off of what you said, Isaiah, I feel like in the context of the pandemic, as well as the Black Lives Matter movement, I've been thinking a lot about community and collaboration and what those things look like in these new contexts that we find ourselves in, and also what does collective care look like. And I think this project is a really good example of what's possible. And I personally have been inspired by a lot of the different community initiatives that I'm seeing, especially in Oakland and in San Francisco. And I am inspired by how people are finding creative ways to connect with one another and to collaborate and to support artists and activists. And so, yeah, I think that's kind of what I thought about when doing this project, and that's kind of how I'm approaching a lot of my creative work going forward, and hopefully this inspires other people to do the same, just because community is so important right now, and being able to care for one another despite the fact that we can't physically touch each other, we can't be in the same spaces.
So hard, man. Mm-hmm. It's so hard not to hug people, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But yeah, just kind of redefining what those things mean to us, community, collaboration, care. I think that's what I've been thinking a lot about, and mental health is deeply intertwined with a lot of those things. So yeah, that's my two cents. But I think community is a big theme has been a big theme in my mind and mm-hmm. in my work, I think, and the work that I'm trying to do. So, mm-hmm.
Wait, thank you so much for that, Natalie. Thank you.
Yeah.
Strength in numbers.
For real.
Now, community is like super important because I feel like a lot of us might not have been positioned in a circle where we can comfortably talk about mental health. I know for like guys even, like it's not sometimes trivial when people are like, oh, I'm feeling sad. It's like, man, get over that, you know, like you'll be fine, blah, 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 blah.
But Jordan would never let you do that shit. And you're like, what are you crying about?
Michael Jordan.
Sorry, I finally watched the whole Last Dance last week and I'm like, fuck, I need to get all my shit. Like, what am I doing right now? But
No, but right, you know, with what Belinda was saying, you know, it's sometimes a little hard to open up, you know, and I think more importantly, it's hard to kind of understand what you're kind of going through. You don't really know what you go through until you kind of talk it out with people. So, you know, like one of the goals for like Nüfly is, like you mentioned, to kind of create this like platform or kind of create like a community where like
a safe space for people.
I think Isaiah also nailed it too, you know, like we just want to be honest with one another, you know. If we like something, like we'll tell you we like it. If we don't like something, we'll be honest with you and say maybe you could do it better. Or if I'm not having a good day, you know, that this is a safe space for you to, you know, be able to talk about that. And we think that if this could happen here on this platform, it can happen in your own individual life too. You know, you could be that kind of like go-to person, like say for example, if I were in LA and I was having a bad time, maybe I could hit up Lucci, you know, and I could say like, hey, okay, or not hit up Lucci. But like ideally just like
I need alcohol.
But yeah, like a platform where, you know, hopefully like especially what Jody just said.
When it's safe, Lucci, not when it's not safe. Yes. Right?
Facts. Jesus. Take care of that first. It was a half joke. But what Jody said too, how she was very open, like this is her first time meeting other people, and that she just like opened up her doors saying like, if you guys want to collaborate on something, like hit one another up. We hope this could kind of become a platform for you guys to kind of say like, hey, you know, like this is how everyone sounds. This is what everyone's work kind of like looks and feels like. It's been great. Miles, do you have any thoughts you want to share with us on the care package overall, or maybe some thoughts on mental health lately?
Well, first of all, like with the package, I just thought it was dope that you guys even thought to do this in the first place. So like, I really thought it was dope that you had reached out to all of us to contribute instead of like trying to just handle all that shit yourself. You know what I mean? Like you like curated all these different like elements to hit different senses, right? Like the candles are amazing, like the music and like the visual, and like it takes care of all the senses, which is really, really dope and well thought out. I think it was really cool that you took the time to reach out to everyone just to like contribute. Like I said, like and we touched on this last time where like I'm not really good at hitting up people, and it's such a downfall because like I feel like in collaboration you can make some really amazing things. As this is like hard evidence for that. Like there's like how many of us who in this Zoom right now, like we all come from different backgrounds, and it kind of created this one beautiful thing. So I'm grateful to be a part of it for sure.
Nice.
How's your mental health been, man?
It's been good, man. I've been taking care of it. I was going ham this week on some shit, and I got like this little net. Like I don't know if you guys know about angel numbers.
I do.
Basically, if you see a number. So if you see a number
1017.
Oh.
1017.
Huh?
So like angel numbers. So like basically if you notice this number popping up a lot in your life, like say like you look at the clock or you see it on the freeway or like you see it wherever, Google it. And then like usually it's like there's gonna be like a message attached to that number. They're called angel numbers. So you can Google like if you see three. Yesterday it was 222. So basically I've been going hard on something all week, which to me I thought was laser focused, but it was like very too focused. And like I got this this message yesterday about balance, which is why I just went on this long ass bike ride right now, which is why I was in the car coming home. But so yeah, after I'm really glad I went on that bike ride because I feel much more balanced and at peace right now.
Nice. So,
yeah.
I'm like super into numbers too. I think Jody is as well. Jody would always be like, yo, it's 111 right now. It's 111. I'm noticing 111 or like 222 or like three. I'm like, what? And then I started seeing that in my shit too. And I'm like, while I'm looking at the clock, I'm like, yo, it's 111 right now. It's 222 right now. What the fuck? How is this? The hell is going on right now? You know, like, are you like doing some witchcraft in my life? Numbers, man. Sorry. I'm just number superstitious as well.
No, that's a real thing. Like, ever since, because my best friend passed away 2 years ago, and like, I always see the number 24 or like 143. Like, I'll just randomly be like, hey, what? All right, love you too. Cool. Let me go about my day. But like, it's a real ass thing. Yeah, no, see, I didn't believe it at first. I mean, I did not believe it, but it wasn't present in my life.
Yeah.
I didn't pay attention.
Gotcha.
And so now it's like, okay, cool. Like, I get it.
Yeah. Yeah, I always see 1017.
Wow. 1017.
Damn, I need to look this up.
That's my birthday, Dawn.
Oh my god! What? Oh my god!
Crazy.
Wow.
Oh shit.
That's wild.
Damn.
What do you guys look at? You like look at like your
you
phone?
Just look.
Like,
okay, you just look. Like, you can't say. Dude. Yeah.
You can't look for it. It has to appear, but you can't look for it. It doesn't work.
No,
it's just, it'll just like you glance at something, you're like, oh shit, I wasn't.
Damn.
You weren't even paying. Yeah. Like you look at the clock and you're like, what the fuck? Like I'm trying to look for the time.
Instead, you get a message.
myself just looking at the clock, turning to 10:17.
Wow.
Like, every time, so it's kind of weird. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna pay attention.
Wow.
Yeah.
Damn, I think I've been paying attention to my.
For real. Same.
Yeah, I have some crazy ass stories with it. So that's another day.
For these stories, tell us one. Give us one right now.
Okay, there is one. When I was seeing 33, like for like a week straight, like everywhere I looked.
33. And,
I remember like I was at home just working, and I wanted to like check. I had this little ass sampler. I don't know if you've ever seen it, Belinda. It's like, it's called a pocket operator sampler.
I have one too.
Oh,
it
shit.
It looks like a calculator. Well, it doesn't even come with a cover. Does yours have a cover? Yeah. Or is it like.
I bought a cover, which I never put on. So no.
Like you actually have to buy a cover for it. It's crazy.
Oh, wow.
The hell?
Yeah, it looks like. Anyways.
Yeah.
So there's a clock on there. And I remember like. For some reason, I wanted to check the time, but my clock was broken on that thing, and it said 33 on it. And then, not even realizing, I have the pocket operator. My model number was PO33, and then like I remember at this moment when I realized it, my shelves fell behind me. Like literally, everything fell off my shelf. It collapsed.
What?
And it was a weird moment. And then like. A piece of gear, like I have another drum machine on these shelves that fell that I haven't touched in how long, and it's like the only thing that was sticking out. And I'm like, okay, am I supposed to use this? So like I plugged it in and I didn't know. Hey, Kaz, did you know you could plug
to use this? Oh,
you could plug in shit like from the pocket operators into other shit, and it like syncs up, which I had no idea.
Yeah.
Anyways, I thought it was so weird that my shelf fell at the moment I realized this shit.
Wow. It would be really hard not to try to draw some connections on like what, why that happened.
Yeah.
Damn. Angel numbers.
Right? But,
yeah, look out for it.
Okay.
Yeah. Damn. Wait, okay, before we end this, can you show them the mixes page on our website? You can just hide the link. Just share the screen real fast. Yeah, because like Don killed it. He made all their mixes look like records, and then he put all the
Don, that was you,
over
dude.
The records. Fire. And
Don,
then the
Don
mixes.
Did the whole website, man. I don't know how to not share the URL, so hopefully if
just open up the page, and then when you have it open, like you delete the link. leaked the link so people can't. It's not like they can even access
it. It's too late. I got it already.
Oh my God.
Okay, hang tight for us, guys. Let me get us the link.
We just want to show you guys real fast and then we can all go about our days.
Yes.
Oh, jeez.
Do I?
You should stop sharing, pull it up,
delete it. Yeah, yeah. What are you doing?
Sorry, we're an illustrator.
You're hella difficult for yourself right now.
I am looking for the link. Okay, I found it. Okay. Okay, hang tight. Okay, now I'm gonna delete the URL and now I'm going to share my screen.
Correct.
Okay. Oh, this should not be so hard.
You got this?
I got this. All right. Okay, here we go. Hang tight. Sharing screen. Share. Okay. So when people go.
No one saw that. No,
it's all good.
Okay. Anywho, with the private QR code that's printed out on the poster zine, when people open that link, it'll bring them to this private page that's not connected to any other link from our website. So there's no way for you to navigate to this page. The layout is very similar on how it would look like on a phone. We have everyone's mixes next to a record vinyl player. This is basically the experience the people who receive the Cure package will be able to go through. And further down, we actually each made a 16 track playlist each. Here's like Belinda's effort on like a relaxing playlist. Here's mine, and here's Kaz, and here is Dawn's. But yeah, so that's how it's gonna look like when people open up the QR code.
Hey John, I love that. I love how your first song is a Don Kez song.
Don is like the most like Bay Area slapper gangster shit out of all of us.
With our powers combined, guys, we have range. We have big range.
We're eclectic over here.
We have come up to our time. We want to be mindful of everyone's time. So we want to definitely leave this on a high note. We want to thank everyone for joining again and also contributing to our Cure package. The great news that we have for you guys is that we're each going to be sending each of our contributors, meaning you guys, one of the Cure packages. So we'll be contacting you separately to get your guys' addresses, and we'll be paying it out of our own pockets just to, you know, be able to support Nüfly also. But we definitely want to give you guys a copy of the Cure package. So that's our gift to you guys, you know, just so everyone can experience the whole Cure package in its entirety. And thank you guys so much. It was a really fun 3 months of like hard work.
Thank you.
Live streams.
Thank you. I'm gonna clap. Like, really clap.
Let's give a round of applause for everyone, guys. Round of applause for yourself too.
I'm like not really clap. Thanks.
Oh dang. All right. Well, you guys are welcome to like.
Should
sign
they plug
right
themselves
now.
Real fast?
Yeah, sure. Actually, let's do that. Let's go down and let's start with Natalie. Let the people know what you're currently up to, how they could follow you, and then let's go down like Isaiah, Miles, Jody, and then Lucci.
Hey, so you can follow me on Instagram at maybe.natalie. I'm in the process of trying to build a brand for my ceramics, so hopefully that'll come up soon and I'll let everyone know. Just doing more ceramics back in the studio. I also do freelance business consulting. So busy with that. And yeah, thank you for supporting. Hey,
thank you, Natalie.
Thank you.
And Isaiah.
You could find me on Instagram and SoundCloud at Isaiah Sab. What's up next? I guess more music. Music to come always. It's just a part of life now. Hopefully you don't catch me in your local ER.
You heard it here first. All right, and Miles.
You can check out my Twitch on Sunday at 1 p.m. It's just my, it's just like twitch.tv slash my name.
Except but, you're not doing it tomorrow.
I am.
Oh, you are?
I'm not gonna be at home.
Oh.
No, I'm not gonna be at home tomorrow. And okay. And I'm working on another show during the week, which we're about to do. That's it.
Ooh.
Nice.
Exciting stuff. Hell yeah. Thank you, Miles. All right, and Jody, aka Arumi.
My Instagram is arumi.cloud, and I'm working on some music right now, so I'm almost ready to release some stuff, so you can follow my SoundCloud at A-A-R-U-M-I.
Awesome.
Yee, can't wait.
Hell yeah. All right, last but not least, Luchi.
You can follow me on Instagram and I think like everything else, I don't know, at Luchi Hugh, L-U-C-C-I-H-U-G-H. And I go live on Instagram every Monday for Elevator Music Mondays. And I'm going to release another EP soon. So.
Ooh.
Nice.
Damn.
Okay. Okay. Love to see it.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much. We'll go ahead and conclude our stream over here. So you guys don't need to stick around for that. We're just going to do our outros as always. But yeah, thank you guys for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Talk to all of you guys soon.
Yes, we'll be reaching out to you guys soon to get your guys' address because we'll be sending you.
Appreciate you guys, man.
Yeah, the care package.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Have a good Enjoy Saturday, everybody. Saturday.
See you guys.
Up.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Later. Have a good
Later.
Weekend.
You too,
for everything, guys.
There's, yeah.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Peace out, East Coast.
Peace out, East Coast.
East Coast.
There we go. Boom. All right. We'll go ahead and wrap up our session, guys. Thank you for everyone tuning in today. Thank you to our contributors for contributing and tuning in today. This was Nüfly session 26. Care package 1 is now available on www.nuflymag.com or Nüfly with the pronunciation tone on top, nüfly.com. We are running low. If you guys want to cop, you should cop now. So go ahead and check that out. Yeah.
I'll be sold out over here.
I am one of your four hosts today. My name is Dan. You could follow me on Instagram or Twitter at DakFu. I'm going to go ahead and hand a microphone over to Belinda.
Hey, you guys. I'm Belinda, also known as _ZenRabbit. You can follow me on all platforms with that username. I'm going to pass the mic over to Kaz now.
What up, y'all? Thanks for tuning in. Much gratitude to y'all once again. You can follow me at SpeakProper on most platforms. I'm gonna go ahead and pass it to my boy Don.
Thanks for joining y'all. Today was dope. Everybody came in, pulled through. Thanks for joining. You can find me at _UOP. We are about to sell out of our package, so go and cop at newflymag.com or newfly.com with the kind of two dots. I think it's you hold U and press 2.
That is right. That's how you do it, man. You hold the U button, and then, well, at least that's how you do it on iOS or Mac OS. Anywho, okay.
Take that.
All right, guys. Signing off. Thank you for tuning in today.
Thank you.
Later, y'all. Have a good Saturday.
Bye. Camera, pull the right, 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 pull the right,